worst of the Opie and Anthony Show. My name is E-Rock, and joining me as always, primetime Sam Roberts.
That's right. And the Opie and Anthony Show may be on vacation, but if there's one thing that E-Rock and I do not do, it's vacation.
Because they don't give us enough days.
Well, I do it because I have a strong work ethic.
I do it because I ran out of vacation days.
You do like your vacation days.
I didn't take every Monday off.
That was Steve, but again, this is not a place to... For your personal grievances, this is the worst of the Opie and Anthony Show.
What we're going to be doing here is replaying the 2006 homeless shopping spree.
Oh, yes.
This was a big one.
Yeah, the homeless shopping spree, to me, is the greatest thing in all of radio ever.
Ever.
Ever. It's, we gather up all our homeless friends that we meet throughout the year. We give them each $200, send them to the mall during Christmas season. All the fans show up. They contribute money. It's a really joyous thing. We take over the entire mall. The homeless people get to go away with some goodies, and everybody walks away with a smile on their face, except for the dopes who were doing their Christmas shopping at the mall and didn't know there'd be a dozen homeless men coming.
Yeah, we had some of the homeless guys that that stood out. Papa Rock.
Of course, Papa Rock and his little amplifier that he always carries around.
Blue was there.
Blue, I was with Blue, the late, great Blue. I miss him to this day.
Blue's gone, too?
Blue is gone.
Half a Hulk face was there?
Yes, half a Hulk face was there. I think he got his picture with Santa Claus. Slow Motion was there.
I don't quite remember him.
He just spoke slowly. He was a large man.
Okay.
Without a home.
Grey Wolf was there.
The infamous Grey Wolf. He wrote the song Shelter Me and recorded it and vocalized it and did all that.
Rich Voss was there?
Yes, the homeless Jew, Rich Voss.
And apparently it says here, this homeless person stole the show, but I don't know this one. Homeless Fez?
Homeless Fez. No, it doesn't ring a bell.
Well, he apparently was a part of this thing.
It was so great. We start in the studio. We move to the mall.
What mall was this?
Short Hills.
Short Hills Mall in New Jersey. Also, I want to point out to everyone who usually writes in and complains, this was simulcast on the satellite side, but on our terrestrial network as well.
That's right.
So you will hear it uncensored, but when they're complaining about certain things, look, it's not beeped. Don't give a shit about this. It's just the way it was back then, and you'll have to deal with it now.
Deal with it.
And you'll enjoy it. And happy holidays.
It's the homeless shopping spree, only on the Opie and Anthony Show.
But enough of this palaver. Let's get the show on the road.
It's the Opie and Anthony Show. The ONA virus spreading across America. Welcome to the homeless shopping spree 2006. Anthony already pissed off. Jimmy just arriving as I turn on all our mics. It's what's the word here in New York City? Chaos.
A bit crowded.
A bit dark. It's a bit dark in Midtown.
I am livid. Livid. I heard nothing of this. This Reverend Al protest march.
Oh, is that what
down
that is?
Fifth Avenue. I had a drive in from Long Island. The drive was very pleasant. Right up until I got across the 59th Street Bridge onto 57th Street in Manhattan, where I was then turned off of 57th. Now, I don't know how much everybody else can understand. Here in New York, you can if you work or live in the city. When you're on 57th and they close it down and you get turned off, 57th is a main thoroughfare across town. The rest of the streets are these double-parked, single-lane, crappy roads that get packed crowded with traffic. And the reason that 57th was closed, because Reverend Al had to have a march...
Today,
down Fifth Avenue, where all the white people shop for Christmas, and completely tie up this effing city.
Why can't they tell him no?
What? That's what I said. In between the use of the N-word, every third word out of my mouth. I set a personal record today, which I'm very proud of, yelling it out the window. In the car, just with the windows rolled up to myself.
Well, I know the old record is 851 in one
blew
day.
Blew it away. Blew it away. And in record time.
Yeah.
Well, I was just livid. So I get turned off at 57. And when you're, you know, driving down and you plan and you're timed out what time you're going to get here, and I have to be here by a certain time. It's my job. You know people. You know jobs. That's places you have to be to make money on a daily basis. Dad, I'm just filling in some people that probably don't have them. When you're on 57th and get turned off of it, you know it's going to tack another at least 45 minutes to an hour on wherever the hell you're going.
Well, this city is a fine organism, and if you block off one street,
yep.
I mean, if one car stalls, the whole city's effed.
The city gets screwed.
It to a point. Driving around in Manhattan, one car stalls or they block off one road, everybody's screwed. It doesn't matter how far you're away from this roadblock or this stalled car.
The ripple effect.
The ripple effect is ridiculous in Manhattan. And just to explain, because people are a little clueless here, Reverend Al decided today to get, I don't know, thousands upon thousands upon thousands of people.
Thousands of black people.
Together to protest what happened there in Queens a few weeks back.
The groom getting shot. I understand. That was a tragic event. Let the judicial system take care of it. Let a grand jury take care of it. Let people investigate it and see what happens. And if then you don't get the answer you want, then do what you usually do. Effing riot. Okay? Let's keep things the way they usually work in this world. But while they're still doing the investigation, could you let Whitey shop? Let Whitey shop!
Let Whitey shop! Let Whitey shop!
You're tying up Fifth Avenue.
Was there a lot of traffic when you were veered off it?
It's like you couldn't believe.
It's a nightmare out there. And how does that pertain to today, besides the fact that Anthony is out of his freaking mind? We're trying to get together this homeless shopping spree 2006. And the bus is stuck in a roadblock. The homeless,
we can't dig up all the homeless we wanted to because we can't get around the city to pick them up.
Yeah, the homeless are not where they usually are because those streets are blocked off for the march. Like, here's something. We can't find Andrew from the cake stomping incident.
Goddamn Led Zeppelin, he is. He's the Who of this event.
He is the star of this year's homeless shopping spree 2006. Of course, the guy where he offered us a cake. I jumped on his cake. Everyone knows the bit by now. Well, he's usually outside a church on Fifth Avenue. Fifth Avenue is the street that is completely closed down for this protest.
Because Reverend Al's got a march.
So then we got a hot tip that Andrew is wandering around Central Park. And, oh, that's an easy park to try to find someone in.
On a Saturday.
Oh, my God.
Unseasonably warm out in New York City.
Central Park is, I don't know, if I had to do a quick guess, 20 square miles. We'll find him.
Yeah, we'll find him.
Andrew.
He's in there somewhere.
And then Tippy Tom, we can't find him.
Can't find Tippy. All because Reverend Al had a march.
Today.
Leave your stupid marches. You know what your marches do? Nothing. Let me make this clear. Everyone's outraged at what happened. Let the judicial system run its course. Your marches do nothing but make people hate you. They make people hate you. And by people, I mean white people. It makes prejudice even more. It makes people more prejudiced. Michael Richards, I made a turn. He heard what I was yelling. He was offended. he told me to stop. I was offending people.
Yeah, they're not getting any sympathy today, man.
And everyone got it from me today.
And all the news stations are on it now, all live shots of this march, because they have continued marching past where our location is, 57th Street, and they're going all the way downtown. And then what? Then they're going to start coming all the way back?
Then they got to get back. That's they don't live down there, that's for sure. You know where they came from?
Well,
up north.
You know, we should get them back and just, shut down the subways.
Oh, my God. No, please. Let them take the subways and get back home.
All right. Giuliani was great. He gave Al Sharpton nothing.
Nothing.
Sharpton.
Why did Bloomberg
rolling.
Give these people permits to march?
Guilty. Why on a Saturday afternoon do you give them a Fifth Avenue permit to march?
A Fifth Avenue permit. This is about when people do their Christmas shopping. Fine. You know something? The guy is so gung-ho about revenue in this city. He's completely effing up the revenue Because if he didn't, he'd catch all kinds of hell, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah, this time of year, it's a zoo in Manhattan to begin with. And then on top of it, to have this march going on, forget it.
Stop it already with your stupid marches. They don't do anything.
But let's stay focused.
They're not garnering sympathy. Making people hate you.
Let's stay focused, though. We're here to do the Homeless Shopping Spree 2006. And I guess what we're trying to tell you guys, it's a complete nightmare so far.
Where's the bus?
Yeah. The bus, I don't know. We're going to start getting some updates. Keith the cop, I just saw him running around. He looks completely exhausted already. He called me like, dude, I don't even know what to do. Like, he was stuck behind roadblocks, and he works for the NYPD. Keith's on a cell phone. He's walking over to a microphone. Keith, what do you got?
A mess. I mean, this was a mess. I've been out there 3 hours running around looking for these guys, and to not have the two stars of the show. I mean, we have Tippy Tom's understudy, Big Red. He's in rare form today. He's grabbing other guys in the van. Blue is in the van, and Blue's drunk, and they're back and forth with each other. Not drunk, I'm sorry.
Yeah, we're not allowed to get the homeless drunk. That's a story for another day.
Look, I don't know what the hell these guys did before. It's friggin', it's in the afternoon.
Who came?
What do you think? These guys go, hey, it's not noon yet.
Who said you can't buy them liquor?
We all got the email.
Just wait for the email.
Just wait for the emails that were sent out the last couple of days.
This issue will come up Monday.
Yeah, we will be strangling a lawyer in Washington.
Yeah.
We will be getting Joel Hollander involved on this one. Holy crap. Wait till we, get into that. Just completely trying to destroy the homeless shopping spree less than a day before we do it.
It's what they do.
It's what they do.
They're not creative. They are just
ruining lawyers.
The business that they are supposed to be helping.
The lawyers are there to just screw things up.
You're ruining the business you're supposed to be protecting.
Yeah.
All right. Anyway, so where are we at, Keith?
All right. Well, we got half of the guys that we know and love, and then we have...
Actually, we still have a good lineup because we're going to go to the mall in a second because the mall is already crazy. We'll get an update from the Short Hills Mall. That's where this bus with the homeless people are heading to in about, about a half hour from right now. But the list I got in front of me, we got Grey Wolf.
Grey Wolf we have, yeah.
The guitar player?
Yeah.
Have him?
I'm running down the list here. We got Grey Wolf. We got David, who's the homeless guy from WYSP in Philly. They brought a homeless guy up from Philly. He's here. We got Big Red, who Keith has said is Tippy Tom's understudy.
Understudy.
We got the Big Red. We got Blue. He's very famous in past homeless shopping sprees. We got Papa Rock, or homeless guitar dude.
Yep.
Who was fiddling and fiddling and fiddling.
Does he have his guitar with him?
Yes, he does. It's quite haggard.
Is it already all beat up? I can't wait to see.
We broke his old guitar. We gave him a brand new one. This
like
thing
how long ago
sweet.
Did we give him a, this
it
guitar?
It was Thanksgiving. It was three weeks ago.
3 weeks ago, and it's already just
It's already
wrecked.
Beat up pretty bad. We have half a Hulk face.
Thank God.
And we have
a
this
star.
And we have Fez from the Ron and Fez show.
Fez?
Yes.
Fez.
A couple people that we picked up along the way. O-Head.
O-Head?
O-Head. He's one of the crowd favorites over at the Port Authority. We picked up Big Pop.
Big Pop?
Who we're going to introduce today. He's also another Port Authority fella.
Okay.
And for the first time, we have a female participant.
Oh.
I think we had one last year.
No, we had her come up, but we never found her.
Oh, okay.
She never.
Okay.
We have Annette. Australian homeless girl.
Wow,
so
that's a long way from
around
home.
The world to become homeless.
To become homeless.
But
she swam?
At one point, she might have been. But I would like to do the thing, and we've done this a lot in the police department, where you see somebody who maybe started getting into heroin, and you'll see over like a year's time, maybe they get arrested 10 times or whatever.
Oh, you look up their mugshots.
Right, the deterioration in the mugshots from a really attractive girl to just a total crack.
Yeah, I've seen some of those online. Very interesting.
And we still have people trying to search out Andrew.
Yeah, Andrew.
Come on, we need Andrew.
Oh, please, Andrew.
Tippy Tom, we had to write off. I spent a lot of time looking for him, and I hit the church on Fifth Avenue.
You hit all the places he hangs.
Every place for Andrew and Tippy Tom, and... They could be downtown in the tombs for all we know.
They might be arrested or in the hospital or who knows.
All right, let's go to No Filter Paul. He's at Short Hills Mall. No Filter Paul.
Yeah, hey guys, good afternoon. I'm standing outside this Qdoba Mexican restaurant on the south entrance to the Short Hills Mall.
Yeah.
And I'm standing with about 150 maniacs who are going to, and outside, there's about 100 people inside.
Let's go.
All right, it's...
You got it!
No Filter Paul's trying to organize the first chant, and it's not doing too well.
No, he's not inspirational.
As you can hear,
no, he doesn't inspire anything.
Yeah, it sounds just like Reverend Allen, the march he's doing. Thank you, No Filter Paul. Let's say hi to Navy Dan. Navy Dan, what's up?
Yeah, actually, I'm in Qdoba looking outside right now, and I see security guys all forming up. You know, there was police that were driving by telling people to get out of the streets. I got here a few hours ago, had like 5 pints with some of the pests. People have no idea what's going on, just watching with their kids, seeing huge crowds form up.
This is very early on, too. Wait till when they arrive. It's just going to be a madhouse.
I got reports up to 300 to 400 people so far at Short Hills Mall waiting for the bus to arrive. And we got some pal talkers. They're going to be at the mall with their cameras.
Yeah, apparently they're going to bring the cameras. So we're going to be able to watch the arrival as it happens on pal talk.
Also hearing there's a 2-mile backup for the exit for the mall.
Of course.
Those are going to be, those are all the pests trying to get to the mall for the homeless shopping spree. Yep. So if you're on your way to the mall, give us a call. Let us know what's going on out there. But I guess it's shaping up. It's shaping up. But it was just crazy about a half hour ago. We didn't know if Anthony was going to make it to the studio. We didn't think the bus was going to make it to the studio. We didn't even think Keith was going to find half the guys he ended up finding. So
that whole march threw a monkey wrench into the whole thing.
Yeah. If we could just get Andrew, then we're in very, very good shape.
Dude, I got spooked. I was like, what's all this traffic?
I know.
It made me nervous.
It did.
I had to get out of a cab on Broadway and walk. I've never had to do that. I left it like 25 minutes up. I'm like, may hit a little extra traffic. I was stopped so bad where open I live. I had to get out and walk.
Yeah.
When they turned me off of 57th and then turned me off onto another road, the traffic, that directs traffic, the ones that want to be police officers but for some reason couldn't
just
pass
dummies.
The test or something like that, so they put a little vest on them and make them direct traffic.
Yeah.
Turned me off of the road, and I had to make a left. And as I'm making a left, there's a car not paying attention to the traffic person coming right at me. So he jams on the brakes and gives me this, hey, what the hell are you making a left for? So I now the windows are down because I'm livid, and I yell out at him, that cop just told me to turn A, you know, I gave him the A-H, that. And then I noticed pedestrians, I'm in the crosswalk now because I'm chastising this driver.
Yes.
So a guy in the crosswalk goes, hey, move it. So now I'm looking right at him, and I go, hey, I go, that idiot over there told me to make this turn. And then I use the J-O, U-J-O guy.
Yeah.
And... He then said to for me to F myself, and then as I gave him the same thing back, and then as I drove past, he smacked my car with the palm of his hand, and I stopped and went and gave him an Opie. I went, oh, you got me. And all it wound up doing probably was making his hands filthy because I haven't washed that truck in about 6 months, so it's filthy. And then another guy... I was livid. So this other guy in one of the livery cars that I get joy over when one of them are found slumped over in their seat with a bullet to their head because they were robbed. Not the regular cab drivers, but the black cars, the livery cars.
Yeah, yeah.
He won't turn. I want to make a left. Everything's open. He's in front of me. He's not turning because they have to do paperwork as they drive. So, beep, I give him the horn. So there's this... I don't know what he was, Iranian, some type of culture that spawns terrorists, was standing there with a stroller and a baby in the stroller. And because I tooted the horn, he goes, why do you have to do that? And my girlfriend flips him the bird from the passenger seat. And then he just shakes his head. And I go, I have to do this because that savage isn't moving his vehicle, and the only reason I'm here is because I blurted out the N-word, are marching, and I have to drive down here, and 2 feet away from him was this black guy who's now looking at me like, did I just hear an all-time record. Way to garner sympathy, people.
Yeah, that's you're not gonna get the sympathy today.
I would love to see you in such a bad mood being scolded. That's the best part to me.
Scolded.
Like,
I was
yelling at
shocked,
and then someone has to yell at you in the crosswalk to hurry up.
God. Yeah, to hurry up. Odin, I just want to gas it and run him over.
Hey, let's say hi to Sonny Farelli. Sonny Farelli.
Hey, boys, what's happening?
What's up?
I'll tell you something. What a scene it is at the mall. There's like about four
300-400 people here, and we've already been spoken to from the cops like about three times already. From just a couple of people just taking it just a little bit too far.
Well, they're very excited. I mean, if you're going to Short Hills Mall for the homeless shopping spree today, all we ask is that you behave. Our listeners have always done that. Have a great time, yeah. But just behave in the end, please.
Have fun. It's going to be a very enjoyable day. It's a beautiful day out there, and when the homeless arrive, the shopping, the excitement,
yeah,
it's going to be great. People love it.
The arrival is the best part when when that bus shows up and the crowd goes nuts. I can't wait for that.
Yeah.
And for the most part right now, the cops are pretty much letting us stay, do our own thing, as long as, you know, we keep in order, you know. So it's working out pretty good so far.
All right. Thank you, Sonny Farrelly. Now, he's staying 400 people at the mall. I mean, who knows? Probably close to 400. Jeff in Pennsylvania, what's up?
Yo, what's up, guys? I'm heading west on Route 24 and trying to get off 7C here. And there's cars already in the shoulder heading towards the mall entrance. This is crazy. We're like a mile away.
Yeah, we need to do traffic reports, too, because people are trying to get to the mall for the arrival of the bus. All right. Thank you, sir.
All right, take it easy.
People are bringing up things that happened in the past that we really need done. The pictures with Santa.
Pictures
every
with
mall
Santa,
has
yes.
a mall Santa. If we could get just picture half a Hulk face on Santa's lap. Getting a picture taken. How wonderful. What a Christmas card. That I want to send that out as my Christmas card.
Last year we had the homeless riding a carousel. Remember, we picked that mall that had a huge carousel.
Yeah, big
inside.
Christmassy carousel, and they're all the homeless are riding it, and the children are fearful, running away, saying, "Mommy, what's that smell?"
Well, we're just about ready. We're kind of stalling, hoping we can find Andrew at the last minute. I mean, it's ridiculous we're doing the homeless shopping spree without him this year. We got my brother Elmo here. Rich Voss is here. Than is here. Steve. They're all heading to the mall to be spotters as the homeless shop.
Then again, we did tell that stupid cake bum to be somewhere, and if he had the ability to be somewhere, he wouldn't be in the predicament he was in.
I know.
We called him every day, Saturday.
Every day. We even tested him every day.
Okay.
Where are you supposed
to
be
Saturday?
Now, you're
going to be here Saturday. Right here. I treat myself.
You dummy.
He missed out on some
like he's got
air.
Satellite radio or a radio or anything.
In the office, I said, could someone call his cell phone?
Yeah, someone call his...
And only two people got the joke. Everyone else was like, well, I don't know his number. Do you?
His number?
I'm like, you idiots. All right, why don't we take a break? We'll take an early break here. Then we're going to talk to the homeless people, get them on the bus, and get them on their way to Short Hills Mall, okay?
Uh-huh.
All right, it's the Homeless Shopping Spree 2006 on the Opie and Anthony Show.
You're listening to the 2006 Homeless Shopping Spree. And now it's time for Getting to Know the Homeless with your host, Steve C.
You're going to a mall today. We're going to give you some money. You're going to go Christmas shopping. What are you going to buy today at the mall?
Sneakers.
Pants.
Underwear, I don't have.
You're not wearing underwear right now.
No.
Stay tuned for another installment of Getting to Know the Homeless here on the Opie and Anthony Show.
Go get lost.
Hey, it's E-Rock from the Opie and Anthony Show, and you're listening to the 2006 Homeless Shopping Spree here on The Worst of Opie and Anthony.
It's Christmas, a time for family, presents, holiday cheer. And a strung-out bum puking into a mall planter. It's the Opie and Anthony Homeless Shopping Spree.
It's the Opie and Anthony Show, the ONA virus spreading across America. This is Homeless Shopping Spree 2006. Everyone's munching down on the sandwiches.
Me and Jimmy are eating the bum's food. They brought in some sandwiches for the homeless, and I hadn't eaten. So I grabbed one of the turkey and cheese sandwiches, and then Jimmy's like, oh, what are you eating? I go, turkey and cheese. He goes, oh, let me grab one. So, you know, better we eat than they do.
They're full in.
Yeah. They're eating, too.
They could eat out of anywhere.
They're eating. Club Soda Kenny, what's up?
They can't afford bread. Let them have
Big
garbage.
Big Blue was very excited to see opening.
He's very excited to see opening?
Opening. Yeah.
All right. Hey, Rich Voss is over here. He's going to be one of the spotters at the mall. Rich, what's up?
I just was in the room with him, and one guy went to shake my hand, and I pushed it up, so he just grabbed the top right here.
Because forearm?
Yeah, my forearm. You know, because I'm just starting.
Why was he disgusted at your little hands?
I don't. he said, look at those midget fingers.
I'm not touching that.
Voss had the observation of the century.
Yeah, that's why we have you on the air.
That's why we tell you.
You're coming up with new material. Who gives gives a crap? I turned your mic on because you had something really good that you said to Jimmy when the mics weren't on.
Well, I was going to get into that. I find it quite...
Holy crap.
All right, all right. I got to set it up. You don't break out with your best bit right from the beginning. I just find it arrogant that you guys, you know, upset about the traffic, you know, that they're protesting a guy that got shot a night before his wedding day to do your dumb little radio bit, okay? Are you that self-centered that, oh, our radio bit is so important, stop everything? You know, well, let's have the protest on Monday or something.
I would go on record and say this bit, this radio bit, is so much more important than that dumb protest. Let Whitey shop.
Let Whitey shop.
Let Whitey shop.
Let Whitey shop.
All right, we got this douche that wants in. John in Boston, what's up? John.
Yeah, John.
Come on, John, you're on the radio.
John's already proven he's a moron because he doesn't understand he's on the air. John, Boston, on the air.
John is filing complaints with sponsors for this awful show that we're doing today. John, come on. You can say whatever you want on our show.
Hello?
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah, then why aren't you talking? You're on the air, you jackass.
Oh, I'm sorry. I really don't talk to people who swear at me. Goodbye.
Oh, faggot. You faggot.
Go listen to the Hillman. You're obviously part of Mantown, you faggot.
I don't talk to people that curse.
Unless they're holding your ears and standing over you.
Exactly.
At least let us curse at you.
Yeah, we didn't even curse at him.
What's up, Keith?
All right, so everyone's having their quick lunch. But for those scoring at home, we have a last-minute substitution. Australian Annette got out of the van and took off running down the street like a lunatic. And we have now replaced her with James, who was a last-minute substitution.
No, betting.
7th Street.
Who the hell is James? We all got our scorecards. All right, so we got to cross out Annette.
Got to change it. Annette's gone. She was the Australian woman.
All right, she ran out of the van.
Would have been the first woman on the homeless shopping spree.
She got out of the van and just ran down the street in a panic.
She probably looked around the van and then realized, my God, I'm a bum.
And Keith said, a lunatic.
We have James.
All right, James is the substitute. So we got Grey Wolf. We got David from Philly. WYSP found David for us.
Yeah, good
we got
too.
Big Red. We got Blue. We got Papa Rock, who's a homeless guitar dude. We got Half a Hulk Face. We got Fez from the Ron and Fez Show. O-Head. Some new guys. O-Head, Big Pop, and now James.
Notice how fast I'm eating. I want this so done and digested before one of them make it into the studio.
Well, they're going to be in here in a second or two.
Oh, my God.
Hurry up. Let's say hi to Patty in Jersey. Patty, what's up?
Hey, how are you?
All right, Patty.
I'm at the mall right now.
Okay.
Well, where's the bus? We're waiting for the bus. Everybody's yelling around here. yelling at all the drivers coming by here.
Is the crowd pretty good?
Yeah, it's good.
All right.
Just yelling at everybody.
Well, we're just going to talk to the homeless real fast in studio, and then they're going to be on their way. All right, they are just out of their minds at the mall already. What's up, Kenny?
I just got a call from Master Poe, who's on the scene at the mall.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah, go ahead. Real fast, Kenny.
He's going to keep things in line at the mall.
All right. As Kenny was trying to talk, the homeless have made their way into the studio. What's up, Blue?
How's your sandwich?
Finished.
All right, listen. What? Big Red, what's up? All right, their mics aren't on.
Yeah, why would they be?
Why would their mics be on now that we...
I think their breath has melted the fine equipment.
Big Red, talk into that mic for me.
Testing.
All right, that mic's
How you doing,
working.
Big Red?
Dear God, you right.
How you doing, bro?
You don't know me, right?
I know you.
You're Blue.
What?
You're Blue. I know Blue. I remember you from last year.
Tussie.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, my God. I knew this would happen. Al Dukes is going to have his work cut out for him today.
This looks like an NA meeting.
Let me. Thank God that mic isn't on because he will not stop.
All right, let's try to control this for a minute here.
With the cursing.
It's going to be almost impossible.
Great old time, right, Aunt?
What's up?
We're going to have a good old time now.
Oh, yeah. And talk about Christmas. You guys going to be getting some Christmas presents?
Tippy. Where my Tippy?
I know. We all miss Tippy, bro.
I do.
We all miss Tippy. We
Tom
couldn't
Tippy
find
died.
Him.
Tom Tippy died.
We couldn't.
I'm going to ask you something. Are you Tippy?
Am I queer?
Big Red wants
Not
to know
that I know
you're
of.
Queer, Anthony.
Not that I know of, but I'm willing to learn.
What do you know about it, Ant?
All right, listen, let's try to control it. So I know, we got Blue. Well, half the mics aren't effing working.
Thank God.
Hey, Anthony.
Yeah.
I want to ask you something.
Hold on. Yeah?
We love. I want to ask you something.
There we go.
Yes. Can I marry you?
Big Red wants to marry you, Anthony.
Big Red, your eyesight must be a little off. Opie's a cute one.
You gotta think he has no teeth, though. It'd be fun.
Oh, he's saying you talk like a girl, Anthony.
You act like a girl.
Well, you know, let me tell you, Tippy Tom, from you, that is a compliment.
You.
That's not Tippy Tom.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, look
that
at
is
him.
Tippy it's Tom. Tippy Tom. I've seen Tippy Tom, and I know that's Tippy Tom.
All homeless look alike.
I know it. And Tippy, you don't look as good today as you usually do. You look like a wreck today. You usually look a lot better, Tippy.
Can we get some more volume up on their mics, please?
Well, boy, is he...
I'm pinned on the board. We need more volume.
I hope we have an 800-second delay today.
You're an asshole.
Ding, that's gone.
All right, listen.
I'll ring the bell every time. There, that was gone.
All right, listen, why don't we take the mic away from Big Red, because we're running out of dump. All right, stop cursing, Big Red.
All right.
And look at stupid me trying to control this mess.
I know. It just, good
all right,
luck.
Keith's got the mic. Keith, help me out here.
A bunch of pirates. That's what they are.
Who do we have in the room? Why don't you just do a quick around the room, let him say something really fast on your one microphone that we know works well, and then we'll get him out of here. Let's go.
All right.
And then on the bus.
O-Head. O-Head's from the Port Authority bus terminal.
O-Head, what's up?
What's up, O-Head?
Like one of the best Port Authority guys you can ever run into if you're traveling.
Yeah.
Get you where you need to go. I also go to jail for doing it, but we all do our best, you know. What can I tell you?
All right, you're going to have a good time. What do you need?
O-H guy.
All right, O-Head,
what's the one thing you need this winter that you want to get when you go shopping today?
A house.
Plus Howard Stern in the fucking mouth.
Thank you.
Go ahead. All right. I bet you Al got that down the hall.
Hey, did you get that one, Al? Okay, Pookie, dump out of the curse words.
All right, there's a big-time curse there. All right, Keith, who else do we got?
Next up is Big Pop.
Big Pop, what's up?
My name's Pop from Philadelphia.
How you from Philly?
Who the hell are you?
Philly representing.
Who the hell are you?
I'm Anthony. This is Opie, and this is Jimmy Norton. And you guys are going shopping today. We're going to throw you some cash, and you can pick up some, I don't know, what do you need? You need a coat, some... A
little bit of everything.
A little bit of everything? Well, that's good. There's plenty of stores. You guys are going to do some shopping today.
What about the young body? Can I have one of them, too?
A young body?
Yeah.
Well, there's going to be a lot of fans and a lot of listeners and a lot of ladies there, so I don't know if you could work it. You got any game?
Yeah, what do you mean by a young body?
Hey, you going to give some pussy up?
God damn, Red.
All right, keep Big Red away from the microphone.
Wow.
Cursing his ass off.
Red is a potty mouth, literally.
Yeah. I want to know.
Smelt that breath?
I want to know what Big Pop means by a young body. Big Pop!
Hey, Keith Robinson.
Big Pop!
Keith Robinson.
What's up?
What do you mean by a young body?
Female.
Oh, you want a young female?
Ah, okay. Well, maybe one of our listeners.
Female. You want
maybe one
male?
Of our listeners that are there. There's going to be a lot of people there to greet you guys. Maybe you could find one in the crowd if you got some game, you know?
I got good game.
All right, bro.
Anthony, I got good game.
You got some old show shit you had? The shirts? The
shirts? We're handing out shirts, right?
All
right. Oh, yeah.
All right, Keith, go ahead.
All right. Here we go. This is James. James is our last-minute entry after Annette took off.
What's up, James? Okay.
What's up, James?
Sometimes they call me slow motion. Sometimes, you know, they call me a different name, you know, but...
I hear you.
As long as they don't forget to call
me but I hear you.
For lunch, you know?
Yeah, don't call me late for lunch.
Yeah.
I hear you. Yeah. And what are you looking for this Christmas? What do you need?
Well, this Christmas, I'm looking to get out of town, you know, find me a nice hooker and...
All right.
And spread some joy.
You
spread
know,
some joy.
This guy.
Spread some joy in the land. Yeah.
This guy finally, somebody with the true spirit of Christmas.
Yeah. Straight like that.
I hear you.
I think he's going to get out and reach out and touch somebody like AT&T, you know?
All right. Yeah. I hear you.
Yeah.
I think he's going to stay in
miles,
Jersey.
You know,
you're not coming back to New York.
You know?
I hear you. Okay.
Do my thing.
Well,
yeah.
Enjoy yourself and Merry Christmas, and you're going to be going shopping with the rest of the boys and having some fun.
Okay. Hey, where are we going?
Short Hills Mall.
Okay, hey. What's that? The Toys R Us?
All right. All right, that's enough from James. Last minute substitution, all right, James.
Yeah, next up, this is Dave. This is the guy who came from WYS.
All right, wait. Big Reds are going toward the mic Jesus. Again. Who's this kid?
I got a bad feeling about this one, LP.
This is WYSP contestant from Philly. This
are you
is
saving
Dave.
Up to be Jewish?
Hey, what's up, man?
How are you
doing, bro?
I'm doing all right.
Yeah.
It kind of sucks I couldn't bring my dog with me, though.
Oh, yeah, no dogs on a bus.
We'll have food there.
Yeah, don't worry about it. It'll be okay.
Who's watching your dog?
A friend of mine.
Yeah? What's his name again, Keith? Everyone's talking. Scraps?
Yeah, this is David.
David, all right.
I'm David. My dog Scraps.
Your dog Scraps.
Oh, okay.
You got a little mohawk there, huh?
Yep.
You always wear the mohawk, or was
that since I was 13.
So ever since you were 13?
Mm-hmm.
Wear the mohawk. All right.
And
any reason?
Nah.
What are you going to
freak people out?
I just enjoy it.
What are you going to get at the mall today?
I don't know yet. Jacket, shoes, I'm not sure.
All right, cool. All right,
yeah,
right
on. Use some shoes.
Thanks for joining us all the way from Philly there, David.
All right.
Who else we got, Keith?
And here we go, Papa Rock.
Papa Rock. Where's Papa Rock?
With the guitar.
Papa Rock, how you doing, man? Rock and roll.
Yeah. I'm only on my first beer. How can I rock and roll?
Yeah?
Compliments.
Well, now, how's your guitar been holding up?
This guitar is compliments of Opie and Anthony and the producers of the show.
And how's it holding up out there in the street?
Well, your signature's running off.
Yeah, that'll happen.
Look how beat up the guitar
looks. Your signature's running off, but Opie's is still bright and clear.
Where's your little amp?
You got 20 guys here.
Yeah, where's your amp today?
You didn't bring
my bag.
So you can't play us a tune?
Nah, not right now.
All right, what are you going to get at the mall there? Almost guitar, dude.
Maybe
another little amp, one that works.
Yeah.
One with lots of knobs he could fiddle with.
Yeah, just something to fiddle with.
Just fiddling with.
Extra knobs glued on to fiddle and turn with.
He likes to fiddle. Who else we got?
Incessantly fiddling.
All right, Scott.
We got
Have
Scott.
A hug face.
Right, of course. Have
What's
a hug
up,
face.
How y'all doing today?
Very good. Have good. A hug face. I think you're going to be a very big hit when you walk off that bus.
We'll see.
I think the crowd's really going to enjoy you. I personally would like a picture with you and Santa at the store because they have like the Santa thing.
Oh, rock on. I haven't done that in years.
I want to send that out as my Christmas card this year. I think it'll be fun.
No problem.
Santa, all right. What you want for Christmas? Just look at him and go, guess.
Yes. Could you just figure it out, Santa?
I'll give you one guess. One lousy guess.
And of course, we picked up Gray Wolf.
What's up, Gray Wolf?
Wolf? How you doing?
What's happening, Obi? Anthony?
How are you, Gray Wolf?
Very good, very good. Your song, of course, huge hit.
I know.
And I hear now we have an extended version.
Yeah.
Can't wait to hear that.
What is it?
It's I also have a record that I was like last year I was performing with a group on 45th Street playing the flute for the guys for Aha. That's the one the song that says Take On Me.
Yeah, well,
and
we're
I did
very
this
familiar with that one.
About Wasclada, which I brought a copy and there's a picture of the guys with me over there. And I talked to my boss. He says to give this to the people here.
All right.
This is a gift from Wasclada.
Right.
And that's it. And I'm still homeless, guys. No matter what, I'm bouncing from one friend's house to another to stay a little cleaner. I've been off the booze. I go every now and then and get drunk, but it's a simple thing. The thing is that if this record will be able to America,
yeah,
to buy it,
yeah.
I talked to Keith about it. I want to put a $5 donation for some kind of coalition that will Keith will be in charge of the money.
Uh-oh,
so
coalition.
We can get homeless people housed in.
Ah.
And the rest, I want to have a nice house for myself and a golf course.
A golf course?
He wants a golf course.
He wants to give the homeless
golf, like the
big ass. So he wants a big house and a golf course, and he wants to give the homeless $5 is what I got out of that.
Nice.
All right. Isn't that what we do?
Yeah, who haven't we talked to yet?
We got this one guy, and I think he just wandered in with the rest of the group because I have absolutely no clue who he is.
What's your name there, gentlemen?
No, sir. My name's Marcus. No, I talked to Kenny, like, I think a couple weeks ago. He's probably buying you guys sandwiches or something like that. I thought he was blowing me off.
Oh, you but you're homeless?
So I'm really happy to be here today.
You're homeless?
I am homeless. I've been homeless for years, man.
Wow.
And it's really nice what you guys are doing today.
Well, we figure, you know, it's the spirit of giving. It's the holiday season, so you guys
whatever.
Ought to, yeah, whatever, you tell it.
All right, cool. We got Mark.
But it is, we got, me and my friend, we took too much drugs last night, and then I was thinking about this thing, or it was in the future where you guys would be looked upon as like forebears of some sort of, it was event, and,
We'll be
probably CGI effects in the movie stuff that happened later.
I love this guy. Wow.
Homeless Matrix.
The Homeless Matrix.
Yeah.
I'm going to work on that.
All right.
I heard there was free liquor as well.
I like it.
Thanks.
The guy that almost fought Mr.
All right,
Pope.
And
what was the key?
No, he's not here.
Oh, yeah. Where's G.I.? We couldn't find G.I.?
No, yeah. He was a no-show.
G.I.'s M.I.A., huh?
Right. Yeah.
And our final homeless person is to my right here.
He was hard to find, but this is... Yeah. What's your name, sir?
$2.
My name is Fez from the Ron and Fez Show, and I'm really not supposed to be here. I have a home. I kind of feel like the fat kid in Shawshank Redemption. I'm not supposed to be here.
Oh, mama.
Fez, you just got to trust us on this one. You are homeless, and we're trying to take care of you.
We're hearing different stories. I heard the story about you at the Apple Store. Looking all disheveled, and people were taking pictures with their camera phones and then sending them in, and apparently you're living some kind of lie. Like, you're homeless.
Yeah, I was mistaken for being homeless on the street a couple weekends ago, and now I'm part of this homeless nativity scene that you've put together here. So I'm really confused on how all this has happened.
I don't know how, I don't know how Ronnie does so well.
Yeah.
You got to renegotiate your contract if this is the case, because Ronnie does well. He has a place to live and everything.
Nice clothes.
Yeah, nice clothes.
Cigars. Nice,
and you end up a homeless bum on the streets.
On the homeless shopping spree. I heard there was a meal, really. That's why I'm here.
What are you looking forward to buying at the mall?
I'm supposed to get church pants. Tight, itchy church pants.
Church pants and cigars, I hear.
Oh, yeah, that's also on my list. Cigars. I can't come home without cigars.
Now, that's odd. You don't smoke cigars.
Yes. If anyone asks, I do. I'm supposed to say I smoke cigars. I'm blinking a code to you. Get me out of this.
No, you belong here.
This looks like the casting call for the part of Grady on Sanford and Son. What am I doing here?
You're in some kind of denial, what it is, and we're just trying to get you to that next step. Because you're in denial. You got to face your life and the way it is. You're homeless.
So what's next? I stay here with you guys, and everyone else leaves on the bus.
Yeah, that's Blue. He's taking over a mic over there.
Well, that's not Blue. It's just really dark black.
Wow.
Well, Fez, welcome to the Homeless Shopping Spree 2006.
No. My only advice I could give you is get a window seat and open it immediately.
Opie, my brother, my sir. Yeah, greatest radio station I ever heard.
All right, thank you.
See, that's it. Jeez. That's a promo right there.
All right, let's go to Big Kev. He's at the mall. Big Kev, what's going on? He has an observation here. Big Kev, what's up?
What's up, guys?
Hey, man.
Your savages are on both sides of the street at the entryway where the bus will be arriving, and they're screaming at the cars that come by. If there's any little kids in the car, they're screaming, there's no Santa Claus.
Oh, my God. You know, our listeners are creeps.
They just ruin everything.
They do.
Well, this will be the final homeless shopping spree.
And they're screaming, whip them out to every woman that passes by. And there's some people who are, it's right by a parking deck.
Yeah.
So people who are going to their cars are getting absolutely whip them out and everything. It's amazing. But there's no Santa Claus. They're screaming it relentlessly at cars.
Oh, Jesus.
Move with children in them.
We better get the bus there quickly.
All we ask, if you go in the Short Hills Mall for the homeless shopping spree, just try to behave. Please. Yeah. We want to do this bit again. All right. I think we're ready to go, huh? Anything else, Keith?
No, that's it.
That's it. We're all good.
All right. Yes, sir.
I'm going to ask you something. If you was in the woods, and you had a gun,
right,
and there was a man eating lion 50 yards away, but you looked up and there was a snake coming down the tree.
Uh-huh.
And you had the gun. Which one would you shoot?
You.
Blue said you.
I assume the snake.
Huh?
The snake.
You shoot the snake?
Yeah, why?
No, I shoot the lion.
You shoot the lion? You know which one I would shoot?
Which one?
The gun.
There you go.
Now I know what I want instead of church pants.
Yeah, what?
A book of homeless brain teasers.
Yeah, that was a tough one.
All right, let's get the homeless out of here. Whoa!
I can't be. I got a cold.
Oh, shake his hand.
Dude, I got
shake
a cold.
Shake his hand. Shake Blue's hand. There you go.
I got a
shake
cold.
Shake his hand.
Anthony, shake Blue's hand.
Shake his hand.
Shake his hand. What's wrong with you?
Shake his
Shut
hand.
Shut up, you jackass.
Hey, Blue, come here. Shake his hand.
Yeah, Blow.
We did. I got a cold. I got a cold.
Shake Anthony's
hand.
Nah,
you don't want to be sick out on the out on the streets.
Okay.
It's all right now, Blue. Just,
no,
right.
No. You guys, they got to get to the bus.
All right.
The listeners are waiting. You jackasses selling me out like that. I could have hepatitis.
Hey, Tippy Tom. Tippy Tom.
Hey, Tippy Tom. Have fun, bro.
Keep going.
Oh, he's all round.
Oh, he is pissed. Hey, they just jumped out. But yeah, Jimmy's yelling, hey, Tippy Tom, the big red. And he turns around and just goes, F you.
He just curses.
Oh, is he?
He does not like to be called
salty.
Tippy. I just hope that our listeners don't refer to him as Tippy Tom when they get to the
mall. No, that would not be good.
Don't call him Tippy Tom. It'll just upset him.
Don't do that.
And he'll misbehave. You don't want him cursing at nice mall people.
You didn't open this while I wasn't looking rub something on it.
No,
you did to a peanut butter jar the other day. Did you?
No, I think Blue just licked the top.
No,
it'll be all right. Hey, let's say hi to Stan. He's in Jersey. I'm sure he's at the mall, Short Hills Mall. What's up, Stan?
What up? Yo, get them guys, them dirty bastards on the bus because that street is insane.
It's insane. All right. Well, they're heading out right now. We'll see where they are after the break, I guess.
Is it possible for?
Thanks, Stan. Huh?
No. I thought something was unimportant. I'll just ask Kenny off air.
All right. Let's go to Jason. Jason, what's up?
Boys, you better get here soon. The natives are getting restless. We're being well-behaved. We're ruining children's Christmases. And we're hiring cabs, if you will, as they pass by.
Our listeners are asses.
There's a good 500 people down here. Debbie, happy typing girls, recording it all for Power Talk.
Wow. Sounds like Nuremberg.
1944.
Oh, wow.
All right.
And it looks like it.
It certainly does.
All right, here's the deal. As we go to break, we got people calling in like crazy. They're sitting in traffic trying to get to the mall, the Short Hills Mall. The homeless are getting on the bus as we speak here. They're on their way.
It's like that scene out of The Honeymooners. I never knew Nazis were so fat.
we'll be listening in as the homeless are on the bus. They'll be singing Christmas carols and all that.
Oh, of course they will.
I hear Lady Di is at the mall. We'll talk to her. Oh,
she should be on the bus.
What a great day. It's the Homeless Shopping Spree 2006.
Spirit of Giving.
On the Opie and Anthony Show.
Hey, it's Primetime Sam Roberts from the Opie and Anthony Show, and you're listening to the 2006 Homeless Shopping Spree on the worst of O&A.
You're listening to the 2006 Homeless Shopping Spree. And now it's time for another Getting to Know the Homeless with your host, Steve C.
When's the last time you had a bath?
The last time I was so...
I gotta be honest, the smell in here is almost unbearable.
Yes.
And it's coming off of you.
Stay tuned for another installment of Getting to Know the Homeless, here on the Opie and Anthony Show.
Go get lost!
We're back with the Opie and Anthony Show. It's the Homeless Shopping Spree 2006. The bums are on the bus. The right. Bums are on the bus. By the way, a quick plug. Our XM satellite radio commercial is all over the internet. All over the internet. Break.com did the right thing. They put us up on their front page. So please, if you're a faithful listener of this program, go to Break.com, check out the Opie and Anthony XM Satellite Radio commercial. Give a lot of love to Break.com because they're really, really helping us as far as spreading the virus of the Opie and Anthony Show. They didn't have to throw it on the front page. They did.
Thank you.
So thank you to Break.com. And please, if you're a faithful listener, please go there, check out the commercial that way, and maybe check out some other videos. Really show them that you appreciate Break.com for supporting the Opie and Anthony show, okay? The commercial looks great, by the way. I've seen it myself 20 times easily. And I was talking to Eric Logan from XM, and the outtakes for the commercial are beyond amazing. We're going to get those up on the internet. There's a longer version of the commercial. We're going to get that up on the internet.
When's it hit TV? Do we know when it hits TV?
It's going to hit TV. I got an email this morning. I think it's going to be on South Park this coming Monday.
Oh, cool.
Comedy Central is going to be all over the commercial.
Oh, are they?
Yes. But once again, please, if you're a fan of the show, go to Break.com and check out the Opie and Anthony TV commercial and show some love to Break.com. They're really, really helping us out today. Okay?
Wow.
Enough of that.
Already have 560 people in Pal Talk.
Very nice.
Already.
Wow.
And the next one down is 500, and that's Orgasms Are Us Multicam Moaning Oral.
Hey, we're right up there today, see?
With 500 of yours. So, yeah, we're beating out pornography.
So basically, smelly homeless, more important than orgasm.
Beating out porno.
Yep. Beating out porno. Only we could beat out porno.
Of course. It's such an important thing we're doing today.
All right. We got Than. He's on the bus. Than, what's going on?
Poor bastard.
Hi. We've gone 2 blocks.
That's about it, huh?
Yeah.
You hitting traffic?
Actually, it looks good going so far, going across town.
All right. Should we give out the route?
Yeah.
So that if people want to maybe tag along and, you know, join the convoy.
Yeah, definitely.
They could do that. Which way are you guys taking?
Let me double check with Kenny. Kenny, do we have a route picked out yet? So people might be able to honk as we go.
Yeah, we're going 11th. 57 to 11 to the Lincoln Tunnel.
Oh, they're taking the Lincoln Tunnel.
Okay.
And then when you get out of the tunnel, what, the turnpike?
And then when we get out of the tunnel, we're taking 24 west to the mall. 24 west to the mall.
All right. Good luck on that road today.
You know, I told you, it's going to be a lot of traffic.
14 and then 24 west. All right, so we go to exit 14 and then 24 west.
Okay. All right.
What happened after we said goodbye to you guys here in the studio?
Was it an easy load up?
Yeah, more or less. Some of the guys wanted to sit a little farther front than we cared for them to.
Well, are you guys leaving through the Lincoln or Holland Tunnel?
Lincoln.
All right, smart move.
Yeah. Mm.
Take the 11th Avenue exit, by the way. Ignore 9th Avenue.
Ooh, look at Jimmy.
Yeah, that's what, tips. That's what they're doing.
Are they going 11th
Avenue?
Yeah,
they just gave all the directions.
Wow.
That's exactly what they're doing.
How am I not listening?
I don't know. That's exactly what they just said. They're taking 11th Avenue down to the Lincoln Tunnel.
Talk about, wow, what a bad
example. I'm looking at you like, did you just have an aneurysm in front of us?
I want to hear that on the replay.
Oh, my God. I'm like, what?
Sometimes you listen back in the replay and cringe at what you said.
Are you a senator?
Oh.
All right, Than.
Yeah, do you guys want to, we've distributed the lyric sheets. Do you want to sing-along yet?
Yeah, we should start with
right
a little
away.
Sing-along. That would be nice.
All right, we'll see how this goes. It's usually pretty smooth. just a second. We're making an announcement. Sorry. Hey, guys, you guys want to do a little sing-along?
Yeah.
Yeah, what the hell? They sound very festive.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, the enthusiasm is palpable.
You guys want to go shopping? Yeah. All right.
Wait, who's cursing?
One of our security gentlemen is very passionate about getting these guys riled up.
All right, listen. Tell the security guys to not curse. It's hard enough to make sure the homeless don't curse.
We're trying to
get as much of this on the radio as possible today.
There's no more lyric sheets for our gentleman friends here. All right, we'll start with Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. You guys ready?
Okay.
Rudolph. 1, 2, 3.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
Oh, God.
Come on, Jesus.
These guys barely have energy, and they're yelling at him to sing louder. They're yelling at him like it's a chain gang.
Oh, wow.
Rudolph, no, 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 no
Wow, that was great.
All right.
I am really getting in the Christmas spirit.
Yeah, anything else to report then?
No, right now we're just warming up, I think.
All right, you're settling in for the ride to the mall. Very good. Thank you, Fan.
And is there a camera on board? I mean, do we have a video camera?
We're rolling the whole time.
Oh, very good, very good.
Is Sam on the bus with his camera?
Sam is here with his camera.
I got my camera.
All right, we'll have a lot of videos up on opieandanthony.com and all the other websites. Cool. Thank you, Fan.
You're welcome, buddy.
All right, let's say hi to John. He's at the mall. We're going to the Short Hills Mall with the homeless people here. What's up, John?
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Oh, my God, this is amazing. The other thing is, the new chant is every time someone pulls over, pulls up with a minivan, they're screaming soccer mom.
Yeah. Yeah, the listeners are very bored, so they're starting their chants over there.
The soccer mom chant, quite that funny.
This is how richy this place is. There's 180, you know how you go to a mall and they have the cars on display?
Yeah.
There's a $181,000 Bentley in the middle of the floor.
Wow. Are people allowed to sit in it?
I hope That'd be nice, yeah.
I'll shut up.
Get some of our homeless in there.
Yeah, just have
four bums in a Bentley.
Yeah, just have them run their hand up and down the side of the Bentley.
Kiss it. Kiss the windshield.
Yeah. John.
Nothing illegal about kissing a windshield.
Yes,
no.
John, how many people are at the mall, you think?
Oh, right in front of me. I had to walk away, but there's literally 400 in front of me, and there's another 200 inside. Just a lot of people.
There's a lot of people. All right, very good. Thank you, sir. Let's go to Kevin in New York. Kevin, what's up?
Hello.
Kevin!
Yo!
What's going on? You're live on the Opie and Anthony show.
What's up, man? Yeah, we're sitting in traffic over here. It's a pain in the ass to get down here.
Wow. I think people went out last night.
Yeah.
I'm getting my first view, by the way, on Pal Talk of the crowd. Unbelievable. They're somebody holding up an Opie and Dopey fired newspaper. That was good.
Oh, great.
And, it's just Happy Typing Girl is going along the line. I guess they're keeping them in kind of a line that's about 15 people deep or 20 people deep and then goes the length of the mall in the parking garage. They're in different areas. So there goes a police car.
See the police car going by.
They're on both levels of the parking garage that I can see, and it just keeps going and going and going. She's turning the camera every way she goes. There are people, crowds of people. There's an officer keeping some order.
Oh my God!
And by the time these homeless people get there, I don't think they know what they're in store for. They are rock stars. When they get off of this bus, they're going to be greeted by thousands of people,
yeah,
cheering and screaming for them. And I think now that, unfortunately, we weren't able to get Andrew on the bus. Not cake. That was my. I think half a Hulk face. I predict
To we'll be
the
star.
Favorite.
Yeah.
The star.
Yeah.
He should be the last one off the bus.
There is, they're setting up police barricades. This is unbelievable.
Yeah, this is huge.
Stupid Andrew.
I know.
Dumb bum. It's like no wonder you have no place to live. You can't be somewhere on a Saturday.
One place he had to be in his whole life.
I forgot.
I had an appointment.
And we all knew it, too. Every day, we're like, you know where you're supposed to be Saturday.
Yep.
Yes, right here.
I'll be here.
Right here.
Doesn't know where here is.
And then finally the day comes, and he's nowhere to
Dummy.
Be seen.
He was going to go get glasses. He needed glasses. He was going to get glasses.
He would have gotten glasses,
that
too.
Dope. But with the dumbest frames ever. That's what I wanted to do. Take him to, Vision Center or something. Have him set up with some prescription glasses with ridiculous woman frames.
Yeah.
He needed frames, and he was going to get them.
Yeah.
Well, I would love to hear from the bus again. I mean, we need constant contact from the bus, I mean, because that's where the action is right now.
They are lining the entrance to this mall. I'm seeing two levels just packed with people.
I got to tell you, we've done the homeless shopping spree. This is the fourth annual, and this is going to be the biggest crowd by far. I mean, by far. One year we had a couple thousand easily.
Yeah.
I think this is way over that.
Going to be
way over
one.
That this year.
Once the people are there, once we get the homeless in and they're shopping. And
these are just the people that showed up early.
Well, because what happens, too, there's people in their cars in the parking lot and doing a little, pregame. They're just hanging out.
Tailgating.
Yeah, as soon as they know that the bus is closed, then all of a sudden all those people will join the crowd. I see Lady Di. I see No Filter Paul.
Oh.
Pal Talk rocks.
Yeah, when the bus pulls in, it is an event. I mean, the cheering starts. The fans line the side of the road, and the bus pulls in like it is a rock band tour bus coming in. And then when they get off of that bus, the cheers that they get.
Hey, someone on Pal Talk could go F themselves. I hate when Opie exaggerates. What am I exaggerating about?
Hey, you know what's not going to be exaggerated?
When reports come in that it's well over 2,000, you're going to look like the ass. I guarantee there's going to be well over 2,000. Douchebag.
Enough. Don't worry, Ope. You will not hear from him again.
Other radio shows exaggerate. We try to keep it pretty honest here. And the best homeless shopping spree we did, there was at least 2,000 people there. And this one's going to be way over that, guaranteed. I guarantee it.
Yeah, we're doing it on a Saturday afternoon in a big mall in Jersey.
Enough with the haters. If you don't effing like the show, then get out of the effing Pal Talk room and don't listen to the show.
Leave.
Who do we got on the bus?
It's me again.
Hey, what's up, Dan?
Oh, yeah, you said this is where the action is, but we're basically commuting at this point, so.
Well, you're our eyes, so tell us what's going on in the bus. I mean, are some of them sleeping? What are they doing? Sleeping. Are they farting? Are they eating? Are they behaving?
Are they reading?
Papa Rock is a,
are they reading? Are they checking their email on their Blackberries? What's going on?
Papa Rock is in a state of semi-consciousness.
All right.
Everybody else is pretty behaved, just kind of looking alert. I don't know. I guess they're bringing their A games today.
All right. I'm going to go right to Rich Voss. Thanks, Dan. Voss, also on the bus. What's up, Voss?
Well, let me tell you, it's not the best smell on the planet. As one was walking into the bus, was falling backwards, and I caught him because I was sitting up front.
Yeah.
When do we tell them that they have to give everything back?
That would be great if they were all arrested for stealing on the way out.
You got to say, their eyes are pretty normal. I don't think that half of them have been on a bus in, 20 years. I think we should just pull into a police station or something. Uh-huh. Merry Christmas.
Happy holidays, bum.
I dare you to yell out, you guys thought you were going to the mall, but you're all going to be arrested.
All right. Hey, you know what? The joke is we're not going to the mall. We're going to the police station. All right? So if any of you guys have warrants, you better get out now. We're not fooling around. We're serious.
Oh, no.
We're going to the police station. So if you have warrants, now's your time to get out.
They're going to jump the driver, you idiot.
I don't care.
That didn't sound official at all. We're going to the police station.
I know.
Yeah.
We're going to see a policeman would have sounded better.
We're going to the pokey.
Hey, Voss, you should do some stand-up on the bus. You should entertain the homeless.
Oh, you want to do a few minutes?
Yeah, just do like a minute.
All right, hold on.
Hey, have Kenny introduce you.
Hey, Kenny. All right. Kenny, you got to introduce me. I'm going to do a few homeless.
Yeah, we got some entertainment for the homeless. Rich Voss, everybody.
Kenny's getting off the bus for a second. He just got off the bus. He's stopping traffic.
Why is he getting off the bus?
To stop traffic so we can get through the tunnel because it's, backed up.
Oh, wow. Very cool. All right. Oh, so we're just about at the tunnel?
But it's like bumper to bumper. You got to see the outside of this bus. You know when you watch Charlie Brown Peanuts, Take Penn that the mist around him.
Yeah,
that's what the outside of this bus looks like right now.
Hey, Rich, what street are you on now? You're on 11th and what?
Right now on 11th, turning as you're going into the tunnel area.
They're doing good.
Oh, you're making a left already to go into the tunnel?
Yeah, we're on the curb. Kenny's stopping traffic. Kenny and I don't know if Jack. I was leaving the studio, I got in the elevator. I wanted to get in by myself and go down. So the door's closing, and Jack puts his hand in it, and every homeless guy gets into one elevator with me. Jack, whoever you are.
Good. Bunch of homeless people and one who will be soon.
I know. The only good thing about this is there's 10 people on this bus that I know I'm doing better than. One thing I know.
All right, Voss, hold on line for 1 second, and set it up for Kenny to introduce you to do some entertainment on the bus. I want to go to Fez, who's also on the bus for the homeless shopping spree. Fez, what's going on?
Hello, NYPD?
No, Fez.
No, Opie and Anthony.
I'm trapped on a bus with homeless people. We're about to enter the Lincoln Tunnel headed towards Jersey.
Fez.
They say if the bus goes any slower than 15 miles an hour, the homeless will lose bladder control. It's like movie speed.
No, Fez, you didn't call the NYPD. It's us, Opie and Anthony.
Oh, hi, guys. Everything's going great.
Yeah, you enjoying yourself?
Yeah, so far. Yeah, I'm really looking forward to it. We're about to go in the Lincoln Tunnel. I'm looking forward to it, just what this bus needs, to get a little darker.
Yeah. I like Fez fits our show well.
Oh, yeah,
he jumps right in.
Any observations there, Fez?
Well, I know, it's the opposite of Rosa Parks. All the homeless wanted to get immediately to the back of the bus, so I don't know what's going on back there exactly.
Are you like the poor kid that always got beat up? You'd have to sit at right behind the driver?
Exactly. I'm trying to get as far to the front as I can.
Now, Fezzi, you're a little scared when it comes to tunnels and bridges.
Yeah, and we're heading into the tunnel. I may lose you here.
Oh, really?
They have cell service in the tunnels now these days.
Yeah,
Fez.
They're in the tunnel right now.
Ever since, you know, that 9/11 thing.
Yeah, but did you ever think what happens if something happens in the tunnel? Wouldn't it be ironic that all the time you've worried about it, this would be the one time that maybe if something happened, you would be trapped with homeless people?
Yeah, these are the people I want to say my final goodbyes to. the people that have meant the most to me during my life.
Well, you enjoy yourself, and but you have Ronnie to really thank for this. He kind of said this would do you good.
Yeah,
you need to get out there and toughen up a little.
He brought it to our attention that you're homeless there.
Yeah,
Bezzy.
I can't reiterate enough. I am not homeless. I have an address. I have a mailing address.
Address? We know about that. We're talking about a home.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll get a new address today.
All right, Fezzi, we got to go back to Voss. He's going to do some entertainment for everybody. Call us on the other side of the tunnel, okay?
Okay.
But for people keeping track at home, the bus is, it looks like it's in the tunnel, the Lincoln Tunnel.
Yeah.
So they're probably maybe, I don't know, depending on traffic, anywhere from a half hour to 45 minutes away from the mall.
That's nice that Kenny can, use some liberties. Yeah. Excuse me, I have a bus that needs to be somewhere.
Let me tell you, Kenny and Jack were great. They just stopped traffic like there was a terrorist attack. He held out his badge, and everybody was... I'm telling you, the guys... Did we just get cut off in the tunnel?
No, we can hear you. Are you kidding me? Voss.
Well, yeah, you want to do a little stand-up?
Yeah, have Kenny introduce you to the homeless.
No.
All right, let's go back. I'm going to cut off my phone.
Haven't they suffered enough, the homeless?
I know. Hold on. Kenny, they want to do a little stand-up. Have them sit down. All right.
Let's sit down.
No.
You gotta wait till they come out.
We just lost them. All right, we'll get them on the other side. Let's see. People are asking why we didn't go as well, because we have to control it from
here.
Yeah, a safe location.
And I have made a vow. I do nothing outside of the studio.
Yeah.
After a night in jail, no matter what, I actually would have gone on this one.
You earned your keep. You paid your dues.
But I know, this is what I would have went on. I just knew this was going to be a big one and fun, and we got cops with us, so there's not going to be any problems. It's a bunch of dopey idiots shopping.
Yeah.
And I couldn't. I really wanted to go to this one, too.
And the listeners that are going to be there would have been really, the energy there would have been so cool to step off a bus and see all those people. But every mission needs a mission control.
We've never been on a homeless shopping spree. We always do it from the studio. It's just a lot easier
to do
the broadcast this way.
It's hard on the fall. It's hard to control. Yeah. We did a bus thing one time. We were going around doing, what was that thing we did? We were just riding around Manhattan on a bus. It was a nightmare.
Just handing out our brand new WOW stickers. Yeah. And we were trying to broadcast live on a bus. It was a complete nightmare.
A couple of people commenting off topic here on Pal Talk about Jimmy's Kiss jacket. The zipper zips right where the K and the I, guess, separates the SS. So it just looks like a Nazi SS logo on the lightning bolts. No, we haven't redecorated the studio.
No. All right, let's go back to Tham because Voss is about to do his set. Tham, what's going on?
Voss is standing by, as is Kenny. Would you like Kenny to give his intro?
Yes.
All right, Kenny, here you go.
Okay. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the homeless shopping spree. Tonight, the greatest show, radio show people ever, Opie and Anthony, proudly present you're the Comedy Stylings of Mr. Rich Voss. Hey, how we doing, folks? All right, calm down. You don't get anything. Hey, the good thing is I'm doing the show for the homeless. I used to go out with a homeless girl, which was great, because after sex, I could drop her off anywhere. You know what I'm saying? Have any of you guys saw me on TV? Have you walked past the store when I was on? We had the real Indian here. And I remember in school when the teacher used to say, sit Indian style, I get a bottle of whiskey and lay on the curb. Now, we got the Indian guy that has major resentment with the white guy with the mohawk over here. Are you upset that this guy has a mohawk?
The one behind me?
Yeah, I mean, you're a real Indian.
Well, he has a reservation.
Red, how you doing?
Yeah, you've been going.
Sure. Nice talking. I've never talked to hepatitis before. Yes, I did. This is a good crowd. Where's Blue from the Temptations? Blue used to sing with the Temps, didn't you, baby? Huh? All right, here's the deal. Before we go to the mall, we're going to stop off at the dentist, okay? You guys should have your teeth. Everybody can get their teeth cleaned, so that'll take 5 minutes. And then we're going to go to the mall, all right?
All right.
It's going to be, hey, you got to wake this guy up, man.
Oh,
yeah, look at this. Hey, is the heroin that good? He makes the guy that look like, who looked into the art look healthy, you know what I'm saying? I just spit on a couple of them that they don't know it.
Doesn't matter, age meeting age, just cancel itself out.
You can come see me if you like.
He's plugging.
I'll be at Caroline's New Year's Eve. Caroline, if you guys could get in New York, yes. Not the one in Parsippany, jackass, in New York. This guy loves me. He's my favorite. What's your name again?
Blue.
Blue, you're Blue?
Yeah, Big Blue.
Oh, I thought you were Ashy. Anyhow, look how dry you are. I'm getting thirsty just talking to you.
You're very thirsty.
I know the struggle, brother. All right, guys. Peace out. Enjoy the day.
Yeah.
If we're in the mall and there's hot girls come up to me, pretend you don't know me. You know what I'm saying? Peace out.
All right, Rich Voss, everyone.
Yeah.
Voss just performed on a bus with homeless people and did well.
He killed.
Funny, man.
He absolutely killed. Voss, good job.
Hey, you want to talk to Voss?
Yeah, real fast.
Hello?
Hey, Voss, great job.
Thank you. That was a good crowd. I think I hit bonus.
Yeah, you felt bonus. Good about that set.
What's that?
You felt good about that set.
I kind of liked it. There was some good crowd work. The one guy, Blue, was really into it.
Yeah.
Right? Although he was looking at me like he probably saw like a Satan head or something on my neck. But they were a good crowd. Red was falling asleep, and one guy's heroin is kicking in.
Hey,
completely out.
Hey, Voss, if you do another set, do Michael Richards' set.
No, I don't want to get to Apollo, man. Anyhow, I'm going to give you back.
All right, see you, Rich.
Yeah.
Rich, great job. All right.
Hello?
Hey, Than, so where are we now?
We're out of the tunnel, getting near the turnpike. It's about to get on the turnpike.
Hey, we're doing all right. The bus is on its way to the Short Hills Mall. Cool. All right,
Than. There.
We'll check in with you in a few minutes.
All right, cool. Thanks.
Thank you. Let's see. Let's go to Ray in Cleveland. Ray, what's up?
What's up, Owen? Hey, this is probably one of the funniest things I've ever heard in my life, man. I really also respect the fact you guys are doing this for the homeless people. And also,
yeah, that's
Voss
secondary.
Got more of an impression than he did in frickin' Cleveland. I mean, come on.
Yeah, Voss killed on the bus, so there you go. All right, thank you, Ray.
No problem.
Big hi to everybody in Cleveland. Let's, this is pretty interesting, too. Paul in Jersey. Paul, what's up?
Hey, what's going on?
Hey
man.
Dude, I'm from Jersey. I just did a walk through the mall, like, surveying it. This is so pompous, this mall. They don't know what they're going to get. I came out the front, and I saw all those people, but everybody's in their cars, and it's causing mass confusion because people are trying to park, and they see all these heads in everybody's car. So there's people just lined up thinking you're leaving, but you're not. You're just sitting in your car, so that there's confusion within the parking lot on that aspect, too.
Oh, people listen to the radios.
Yeah, you got to think there's a few hundred people just in cars listening to the show.
Until yeah, because they want to hear the show until the homeless get there.
Yeah.
And then people walk to their cars, and of course, in a crowded mall parking lot, you think that means they're leaving, and you can then get the parking space?
Yeah.
Oh. Well, people are getting all mad.
Why is that guy with a mullet opening a Pabst Blue Ribbon in his car and laughing?
Pabst.
How long are you going on Free FM? You're going to go over on Free FM?
Until it's over. I don't know. And for the people listening right now, you're not going to miss anything because they're going to rebroadcast this whole show on Monday morning.
Yep.
Because I'm going to go get an FM radio now.
All right.
My XM doesn't work in there. So.
All right. Thank you, Paul.
All right, no problem.
That's odd.
All right.
In the emollients.
All right, traffic.
Oh, in the mall.
Traffic insane. Brother-in-law working security at Short Hills today. It's his first day.
Oh.
Love what you're doing for the homeless. It just goes on and on. Okay, why don't we step aside? You know, we can play this when we get back. Grey Wolf attempted to do another version of Shelter Me.
Wait, was this the one we had already heard? Like, he did a longer one that we heard at the mall last year?
Supposedly, someone got to him. This week, and he tried it again. Here's the original as we go to break. One of our homeless friends, he's on the bus. His name's Grey Wolf. He came up with this little ditty on the spot for Tippy Tom. It's a song called Shelter Me. He just made it up on the spot. And then Drew Boogie took what Grey Wolf did, put it to music, and it's just terrific.
Yes.
And we'll continue with the Homeless Shopping Spree 2006 on the Opie and Anthony Show right after this song and a quick break.
Let's see how this comes out.
All right. They're right there. All right, here we go. I got it.
About a man, and he always was so lonely at night, but his voice was rowdy, you could hear it all through his train station, and I'm gonna sing this one. This is about Tippy Toe Tommy.
Let's go, away yo.
It's late at night, and I have no plan to go. Money's gone and also all my friends. And the cop says to me, hey, you smell bad, get out of here. And he says, and you don't have an angel. And he said, that angel, shelter me from the falling rain.
You have homes.
This is my life.
Hey, it's E-Rock from the Opie and Anthony Show, and you're listening to the 2006 Homeless Shopping Spree here on The Worst of Opie and Anthony.
There's a sale at Penny's.
Yeah, man!
And a drunk bum running up the escalator. It's the Opie and Anthony Show Homeless Shopping Spree.
It's the Opie and Anthony Show. That's Gary Hoey, by the way.
Gary Hoey.
Ho, ho, hoey.
Ho, ho, hoey.
It's the ONA virus spreading across America. Today, it's the Homeless Shopping Spree 2006. So far, so good, Anthony. The bus is on its way to the Short Hills Mall, or the mall at Short Hills.
Yeah.
We're going to say hi to Danny on the bus in a second, but first, let's go to Melanie. Melanie, what's going on?
Hey, guys, what's going on?
You're at the mall?
I'm at the mall right now. I'm from the town over, and I know the Short Hills Mall really well. And I just want to say that it's crazy here. They blocked off, like, two of the main entrances.
Yeah.
So it's kind of hard getting in. So, but where everyone's at, I mean, people are hanging off the parking decks. Like, it's just packed.
Oh, man.
Awesome. It's awesome.
I can't wait to see the video and the pictures because I can't imagine. Yep. We're getting glimpses every once in a while from the Pow Talk cameras. They're on site. But their batteries are running out, or they're trying to save power.
Yeah, they're saving power. So
it's kind of like a NASA mission. Every once in a while, you get a little glimpse, and then
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
They got to shut down power to save batteries.
Until the big moment, you know.
Until the big
touchdown.
Moment. Right.
No, it's crazy here. I mean, everyone is just so excited for the homeless people to come and enjoy themselves.
Right on. Thank you, Melanie, for the update.
No problem, guys. Have a good holiday.
All right, let's go to the bus, see where they're at. We got Steve. Steve, I'm sure, is just thrilled to be on the bus with the homeless.
The clean listeners.
Yeah. What's up, Steve?
Hey, boys. How are you?
What's going on the bus there, Steve?
Well, the stench is really starting to move from the back of the bus to the front of the bus. I couldn't be happier about that. I'm actually trying to break wind to offset it, but it's not working.
Break wind.
We're moving nicely. It looks like we have a state official. Or no, we don't.
Oops.
Oops.
You guys are on your own, aren't you? Wink, wink.
Yeah,
nudge.
We're on our own.
Yeah.
But it looks like we're gonna be hearing another Christmas carol, Danny.
Yeah.
This one is called Pendulum. It's from the band Foundry.
We actually handed out some of the Foundry CDs I had left over.
Did you?
I had about 900 of them left over, actually.
And the homeless don't want them.
Hey, Steve.
900.
Hey, Steve, any problems on the bus?
Okay. What's that?
Any problems on the bus?
Hold on, I can't hear you. There's a bum making noise.
Any problems on the bus?
No, not at all, actually.
No.
I think Blue got a little bit upset before when you played the Grey Wolf song.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got a little bit jealous. He heard the tribute to Tippy Tom, and he got a little bit jealous and started making some noise. But that was very temporary. But everybody's actually been pretty subdued so far.
Okay. Boy, he can't stand Tippy Tom.
No, we can't.
Red doesn't like Tippy Tom.
No. Oh, Blue hates Tippy Tom?
Blue doesn't like him. Why was Blue getting upset?
I don't know. He heard the song and he got all upset and all, he was all...
Well,
ornery.
Why ain't there no song about me?
Why don't we go talk to Blue real fast? I hate to do this to you, Steve, but I know.
Stinks. I hate this.
He really does.
Jesus, now this one bumped in my way. Hey, Blue, they want to talk to you. Here.
Oh.
Hey, Blue. Blue.
Okay, what?
Blue, why did you get so upset when is he just going to yap over me?
Probably.
So hard to talk to the homeless. Blue.
Well, why you want to talk to the homeless? Why don't you want to talk to Big Blue?
We're talking to you, Blue. Why were you upset when you heard the Grey Wolf song?
Hello.
See, it's this is why they're homeless.
He's talking into the earpiece and he has the mouthpiece by his ear.
What is this thing?
All right, let's try again. Anthony, why don't you try?
Blue. Blue, why were you getting upset and ornery when the Grey Wolf song?
Opie Anthony, I love y'all guys.
There's no... Yeah. You might as well just throw a cell phone into a monkey cage and expect to get some kind of an answer from him.
Oh, my phone had bum cheese on it.
Ah, bum cheese. That's good.
Wow.
I gotta disinfect my phone now.
Wow, that does not sound like a happy situation to be in.
No.
I'm glad I'm not on that bus. If we had gone, of course, we would have pulled up first in a nice limousine or something as a prelude. But these poor bastards that have to ride on this. Danny's on the bus, too?
Yeah, let's say hi to Danny. Danny.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
What's going on? Just so you guys know, the reason that Blue couldn't hear you is because he had the earpiece of Steve's phone pressed up against his cheek.
Dope.
That might have been a reason why he couldn't hear you guys.
They are just dopey bums.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. How is it? What's the atmosphere like in the bus? And by atmosphere, I don't mean like the feel. I mean the real atmosphere, air-wise. What is it like?
It's very thick. There's no other way I could describe it besides thick.
Isn't that true? When the homeless come in here, like before, when the whole crowd is in here, it's a thickness that the air takes on. It's a heaviness.
It's pungent.
Pungent
is the word.
That's exactly pungent.
Because their odor is so deep. It's such a deep, it's a dull odor.
Dank.
Dank. It's a rotting odor. They're odoriferous fungal masses.
Many parts of their bodies rotting away.
Yeah, rot.
There's
a rot, moldy, dank, dark, deep heaviness.
They smell like the opposite of money.
Danny,
yo.
Any other observations from the bus? It's been a pretty pretty tame ride so far?
Yeah, they're being very, very behaved. It's funny because Grey Wolf, the entire time, I don't think has once gotten off of his cell phone.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
It's nice to see a homeless guy with a cell phone, by the way.
And, you know, during one of the breaks, Blue was singing Silent Night, so I thought it would be a good idea if he sang it on the air.
Yeah, let's do that. Let's get Blue to sing Silent Night by himself. In honor of Ziggy, who passed,
Ziggy's song.
That used to go on the homeless shopping spree.
He's got the words in front of him. All right, you ready? You're going to sing Silent Night, all right? Go for it. Silent Night. Holy Night. All is bright. All's memory. You got the words in front. Come on. But see in heavenly. Yeah, I think that's about all we're
going to
get.
Blue is a dope.
He stinks.
And by the way, I brought the Polaroid camera in case anybody wants a picture with half a Hulk face later.
Yeah. Oh, nice. For $5.
Boy,
of course.
Oh, yeah, we're doing photo ops with half a Hulk face as well for the people that show up at the mall.
Danny, how much are the photos going to be?
Photos, I think they're going to go for $5.
Hey, Danny, I want to talk to some more of the homeless people. Who do you think will be good right now?
I would give you to Tippy Tom. But he's cursing way too much.
Yeah,
he's a loose cannon.
Hey, Danny, just say, hey, Tippy, do you want to talk to the guys?
Yeah.
Hey, Tippy Tom, you want to talk to the guys? Yeah, suck my dick.
Danny goes to Big Red, hey, Tippy Tom, you want to talk to the guys? And he goes, suck my...
He was very upset.
He's ornery.
He gets so pissed.
He gets... Man, can you imagine there's going to be about 1,000 guys cheering Tippy Tom?
Tippy Tom.
When Big Red gets off the bus.
They're all going to be Tippy Tom. Yeah. Tippy Tom.
Danny, anyone else we could talk to right now?
I got this one guy here. I think his name is Les or something. Les, hang on.
Oh, Fez.
Ah.
Yes, from the Ron and Fez show. He's in denial still.
Yeah.
He still thinks he's not homeless.
Poor guy.
Brown, 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 brown. The smell on the bus is booze and crap, booze and crap, booze and crap.
I don't think that's the way that song goes. Are you having a good time, Fez?
We just did have a nice moment. We passed Rahway Prison in New Jersey.
Yeah.
The homeless got to wave to their friends.
You know, this isn't just about helping the homeless out. You're near homeless, but it's also about kind of, you know, getting you out and mingling with people.
Yeah.
You know, for some reason, all the homeless have decided to use the bathroom on this trip. It's a short trip to the mall.
They
all had to go use the bathroom. The bad part is, there's no toilet on this bus.
I was going to say.
They all use the bathroom.
I was going to say, I don't remember there being a toilet, but now it makes perfect sense.
Oh, yeah.
I hope it's Steve's stupid laptop bag.
And I do have one complaint.
Yeah. Oh.
You know, I was nervous going through the Lincoln Tunnel.
Yeah.
You know, we finally got out the other side, hit the light of day. My brooch was missing. Where's my brooch? My brooch was missing. When the lights came back on, my brooch was gone.
You gotta watch them, Fez. They're not the most honest people.
No, not at all.
They're used to that. That's something you're going to have to figure out how to do when you're completely homeless is, you know, take advantage of people when they're sleeping or in the dark or something like that.
Exactly. You know, what's nice is the bus company. This has got to be the last time they're able to use this bus.
Before they retire it.
Done.
It's going to have to be burned.
This bus is going to the yard after this one.
The only use for this bus now is that they're making one of those man-made reefs, and they dump it in the hot.
Yeah, a reef.
Like they do with old subway cars.
Yeah.
Yeah, right on.
It'll help the fish.
All right, Fez. Hang in there. Hey, can we talk to Kenny? I want to get here he is. Let's say hi to Kenny and then get an ETA. Kenny.
Hello. Hello, fellas.
Hi, Kenny.
Are you hanging in there, buddy?
What's that?
You hanging in there?
Oh, yeah. No, we're going smooth. If there's no traffic, we'll be there 10, 15 minutes.
Oh, wow. That'd be great.
Yeah,
oh, my God.
Everything's going good. We're segregated on the bus.
Segregated? How do you mean?
Smelly and non-smelly?
Homeless people in the back and normal people in the front. And then Voss.
And then Voss. Voss. They don't know where to place him.
Yeah.
People God loves in the front, people God doesn't love in the back.
Yeah. So everything's going real good.
All right. Any other observations, Kenny?
No, I've been concentrating on just, you know, getting us there, so.
All right.
I leave the funny to you guys.
Right, hey, Kenny, when you jumped off the bus with Jack, what did you say to those traffic people who are not real cops in New York?
No, I know what I'm doing.
Okay.
All right, let's go to Danny. Thank you, Kenny. Back to Danny. He's
Thanks
also
for leaving
on the
me
bus.
Out there.
Yeah, no kidding. Danny, what's up?
Well, apparently the similarities between Tippy Tom and Red continue. Security had to intervene and kind of hold him back because he was trying to get to me because I have a, quote, nice round ass. he wants to stop making eye contact with me.
Hey, Danny, why don't you show him?
I'm sorry?
Yeah, Danny, moon the homeless, will you?
You want me to show him?
Yeah. Look, I've seen it in that little Borat bathing suit. It's fantastic.
Yeah.
That is nice.
All right, Danny, go ahead. Moon the homeless.
Hey, he's trying to grab me. Stop it.
Stop it.
Hey, wait. Hang on.
Danny's not drunk enough for that.
No.
Bob, that Red likes it. Yeah, Tippy Tom loves it. You like that, Tippy?
All right, very good.
I'm not Tippy Tom.
Smacked the phone out of my hand.
He smacked the phone out of Danny's hand after he called him Tippy Tom.
All right, Danny, thank you.
All right, guys.
All right, we'll check in.
Well, that's great. If
in on the bus in a few minutes.
There's
here.
No traffic, Kenny was saying, about 10 minutes. I know that there's. We had reports of some traffic going into the mall, so they might have to deal with that. But the mall, from what we're hearing reports, packed. The parking lot full of fans waiting for this bus to roll in and the homeless to come off like rock stars.
Yeah.
Fantastic. What an event. I would love to be there.
By the way, I want to thank the Hard Rock Cafe for feeding the homeless today.
Yes.
In Times Square, 42nd Street and Broadway. Also, the red carpet, courtesy of Flemington Department Store.
Isn't great. They eat from the Hard Rock, and it comes out the same way, I bet.
And they sleep on the same thing.
Route 31 in Flemington, New Jersey. And Innovation Luggage at Short Hills Mall donated a bunch of backpacks and lunch bags for all the homeless.
Yeah.
Very cool. InnovationLuggage.net, I guess, is their website. Let's go to the mall. I want to hear from some of the listeners at the mall if they're listening in right now. Let us know what the scene's all about over there.
Oh, my God.
Bill, what's going on?
Hey, what's up, guys? It's Bill from Towns River, a.k.a. Bill and Beth from Pal Talk. As you guys can imagine, it's kind of hard to hear. The crowd is getting really loud, anticipating the arrival of the bus. I'm standing here as a shock to me. I just happen to be next to No Filter Paul and the retarded learning Laverne and Shirley. Listen, I didn't ask to be here, but this is where I'm at.
He didn't ask to be here.
I'm going to get a little Owen A chant. All right, Owen A.
That's right.
Guys.
Wow.
Anxiously awaiting the arrival. Built from Tom's River. We're figuring, what, 10, 15 minutes?
Yeah, that's what they're saying. So, you know what?
Guys,
thank you, Bill.
All right, guys. We're waiting on you later.
All right.
Won't be long now. Won't be long now.
Maybe it would be really smart to take a break. So when we get back, we'll be back live for the arrival of the bus.
Big moment.
The mall at Short Hills for the homeless shopping spree. This is the Opie and Anthony Show.
Hey, it's E-Rock from the Opie and Anthony Show, and you're listening to the 2006 Homeless Shopping Spree here on the Worst of Opie and Anthony.
Does he have a pulse?
Yeah, does he have a pulse?
Oh, oh my God. No, I'm serious.
We could have a problem.
Uh-oh, he might be dead.
Aw, I hope he didn't kill the homeless guy.
It's the Opie and Anthony Homeless Shopping Spree.
Welcome back to the Homeless Shopping Spree 2006.
And, we're almost there, kids.
That's right. It's the Opie and Anthony Show, by the way. They are at the mall.
They are at the mall. Where exactly are they, though?
I don't know. We're going to go to the phones and find out. Who do you want to talk to? Rich, Keith, Club Soda Kenny? Let's start with Keith the Cop. This is kind of his baby.
Yep.
Keith.
Gentlemen, we
at the Short Hills Mall. We are currently setting up the walkthrough in the crowd. We're lining our boys up, and we should be bringing them off the bus in about 2 minutes.
Now, you got a crowd of people there? Oh, my God. I guess so.
I think the listeners found the bus, huh?
As a matter of fact, too.
All right, hold on, because we want to do this right on the radio, okay? Hold on. Let me talk to Rich Voss really fast. Rich, what's going on?
It is unbelievable. It's like a rock concert. You got to hear this. It's unbelievable. I can't even hear you guys. Listen. It's all over the place, and half these fans look homeless themselves.
Rich is killing today.
I can't hear a word.
Bro, they can't even hear us. This could be a problem.
Do we have camera?
Can you hear?
Yeah, what's up there, Rich?
I think we're going to do intros. We're making a path so they can walk right off the bus into the mall here.
Okay. Yeah.
The security, it's unbelievable. And they're lining up on the parking garage up on the upper deck there.
Now, we need this to be, when they come off that bus, not too close to the front doors. We want everybody to be able to see these people.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, no, they can see them. There's a path. You know, there's some street, a little street here, sidewalk.
All right.
An old security man.
And how many people are there right now?
Well, you know, they're all into the mall. Look into the mall. It goes all. I swear to God, walking through here, you're going to feel like Moses. There's people all the way down the mall, all the way outside the mall here.
You can't even really judge.
It's unbelievable. And these are only the people that can get to this spot. So, you know, they're even farther into the mall here.
All right. We need the Pal Talkers to turn their cameras on for us because we need to take a look here.
Do we have a mall cam?
The Pal Talkers have been helping us out today big time, giving us some pictures.
They're trying to save their batteries. But if someone in Pal Talk could turn a camera on if you're there.
This is the time to turn it on.
Yeah, this is you want the intro.
Yeah.
Deb is saving battery. For what? This is the part.
All right, hold on, Rich. I'm going to go back to Keith the cop. Keith, what's up?
Hey, what's up, gentlemen?
All right, so what's the deal?
We got the, we're just lining them up right now. And like Kenny and Voss said, I mean, you can't even see the end of the people down the hallway in the mall. It's unbelievable.
God, and they're watching from the parking garages, the levels of the parking garages, the parking lot. It's going to be like rock stars coming off of this bus.
Now, Keith, is this the biggest homeless shopping spree yet?
This could be all the homeless shopping sprees we've done combined. It's unbelievable.
Wow. Awesome.
Awesome.
We're going to start getting the crew off, and then we're going to hit the introductions in about 2 minutes.
All right. There's got to be 100 people there, though.
It could be a couple more than that, Jim.
Hey, who's going to do the intros today?
Let's get them up to the front.
Who's going to do the intros, Keith?
I think we're going to pass it around a bit. I'm going to do a little
Wow. The door must have just opened.
Yep, the crew's heading off now, and we're going to get to the...
Wait, just don't do it yet, kid. We got to get the cameras on.
Yeah.
All right, you're probably not going to be able to hear us during the intro, so we're just going to plow through it. We'll take a break in between each one, but...
Yeah, Keith, just do the best you can. We're just going to listen in, so don't worry about us. You know, introduce each guy, let them get their applause, and then move on. You know what to do. Don't worry about us. Just keep going.
Pandemonium.
Alright, we're coming.
Hold on, Keith. We just gotta get a camera on if possible.
We're trying to get one of the Pal Talkers to turn their camera on.
Alright. Alright, I think we're getting ready to go. Boss is gonna do the first couple introductions.
Yeah, they can't hear.
They can't hear. It's alright.
I wish he had a full horn. Which one's out?
Right. Hey, Keith!
Wow. I think we need a phone closer to the person that's announcing.
Yeah, Rich.
That would help. Maybe try Rich.
All right. One more time. His name is Big O. That's what he goes by, but it's really a zero. I've been here for
We got to fill in the blanks. Obviously, they're introducing the homeless, but there's just way too many people. They just introduced Big Pop.
Huh? Big Pop.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hold the phone up so we can hear him, too.
Absolutely. All right, next off the bus, we have our contestant from WOSB in Philly. All the way from Philly, David!
All right, we can hear a little better.
Our next contestant, his name is James. They also call him Slow Motion. You remember him from the Watermelon Man. Here's James!
James? I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, all right. We tried to get this next contestant, Dave Navarro, but we got stuck with him. Here he is, Papa Rock!
Papa Rock!
Papa Rock.
Papa Rock.
Homeless with his guitar. Dude. The fiddler. Just introduced Blue, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And this next guy, do not litter in front of him because a tear will come from his eye. Let's have a big hand for from the Buffalo Head Nickel, Grey Wolf!
Ooh, Grey Wolf's a star!
Grey Wolf. They love Grey Wolf.
Half a Hulk face. What are they saying?
Half a Hulk.
Okay.
They love it. The phone's obviously having a hard time picking up all this, but...
All right, wait.
He says he's not homeless, but you can see him muttering around the streets of Manhattan.
Fez from the Ron and Fez show.
Yes.
Why am I following half a Hulk face?
Last but not least, you know him as the original Golden Bun. Get me down!
Oh, Jesus, what, did he smack the phone?
Yeah, I think something went on. All right, now they're giving his real name, Big Red.
That's the end of the intro. We're going to head into the mall. Stop breaking up the group. We'll check back with you guys in a couple minutes.
All right, good job, man.
All right, keep the cop, everybody.
Hi, Steve. How are you?
What's going on with the camera?
Oh, retarded Laverne and Shirley. I hear them.
Yeah.
Yuck.
All right, so here's the update. Let me go to Danny. Danny's at the mall. Hey, Danny. Danny! We lost Danny?
Yeah.
All right, so...
Obviously, the phone's having a very hard time picking up the sheer amount of sound that was coming out of the crowd over there while they were introducing the homeless, getting off the bus, gearing up for the homeless shopping spree inside the mall. I'm thinking, perhaps, because, you know, we're doing this live and on Saturday, but we will replay this Monday. Hopefully, Sam... has this all taped with his camera, and perhaps we could pull the sound of the intros and them coming off the bus,
yes,
and put that in the place of the phone,
yeah,
audio, so that way it'll sound a lot better on Monday.
Or at the worst, it'll be up on opieandanthony.com.
Well, yeah, but
whatever they figure out.
I'd like it to sound really nice on the air on Monday when we replay it. So if that's at all possible, mm-hmm, of course, that would sound a lot better than just the phone connection. But yeah, all this will be the video. You'll see the audio and the photos that our people are taking and the fans are taking are going to be all over the place. So you'll get a really good view and the sound of what's going on the smell, which is good.
We should have sent our own guy. We didn't think we should have sent the Paltalk camera down. That was something we should have had with Paltalk.
Well, the problem is there's so many people trying to check out the Paltalk cameras.
A lot of traffic.
Too much traffic. We can't get it working right.
Yes.
We want to get a peek at what's going on over there.
Deb's camera seems to be the one that is the one that won't come up.
Right, and that's the one we really need.
Yeah, that's the one we kind of need.
She's probably very frustrated, too.
I bet she is.
But just to give you the visuals, obviously the bus, you know, pulled up to the mall. There was just who knows how many people. It just sounded like thousands. I don't know. We'll get the numbers later on. And, you know, as Keith was introducing these guys one by one, they would step off the bus, and the crowd was just giving them nothing but love. Let's say hi to Danny. He's at the mall. Danny.
Hi, guys.
All right, what's going on, Danny?
Unbelievable. I can't even estimate how many people are here for this thing. There's that many people. It's like a sea of people. It just never ends.
Yeah, like fill in some of the pictures for us. When the bus pulled up, what was going on?
Everybody was just losing their minds, and you should have seen some of the actual customers of this mall just be absolutely disgusted.
Where, when you guys pulled in, was the crowd chasing the bus? Were they opening up like the Red Sea?
Well, basically, they were like on the side of the entrance, and I mean, it was as far as you could see, there was people, and you know, it looked like a lot of people, and it was. And then we looked inside the entrance, and it was just flooded with people. Like it was three times as many people as we thought it was in the first place.
Wow! So the entire mall, yeah.
Unbelievable here.
How many people would you estimate?
At least 2,500 people. It's ridiculous.
Oh, my yeah.
God.
Great.
This is easily the biggest one we've ever done.
Hands
yep.
down.
Hey, Danny, does it look, do these people look like the normal shoppers at the Short Hills Mall?
Oh, yeah. Dude, when we pulled up, everybody started screaming at the top of their lungs. And there's a couple of really old ladies. They almost fell down.
You just don't get it.
Unbelievable. So
never seen anything like this. Ooh.
And then as the homeless like got off the bus, what was the feel?
It was actually, you know, everybody was really cool. They were very excited for everybody to come off the bus. And these guys are going to walk away with so much stuff. I mean, just the amount of people here that are going to buy stuff for these guys. They're going home with way more than those $200 gift cards we gave them.
Do you know the ovation that stupid Andrew would have gotten if he got on that bus? That dope?
Yeah, and the actual Tippy Tom.
Yeah, we're done with Andrew.
Well, dude, he's a homeless guy. We don't know where it happened to him. He might have fallen asleep, so he can't even maintain a house.
Who cares? We're done with him. We're so done with him.
That's funny. He's irresponsible.
Right. Hey, Danny, have you guys all split up now? Or?
We're done with Andrew.
No, not yet. We're about to do that. And what I didn't even realize was as many people as there are on this main floor, I just looked up, and the railing of the second floor is just lined with fans looking down.
Yeah, looking down. So there's, like, multiple levels of fans that are here. Boy, these homeless are really going to make out today.
All right, Danny, hold on the line. I'm going to go to Rich Voss really fast. It's going to get fast and furious now. Rich, what's going on?
You got to see the looks on the shoppers' faces. They're covering, like, their baby's eyes and stuff. It's like they're fighting to death.
It seems like a nuclear war to them.
They're pushing through. Right now, they're pushing their girls through, like, don't talk or touch. You got to see the regular people.
Hey, Rich, is the mall crowded?
It's unbelievable. I can't believe that you would pick the Short Hills Mall. The only mall where your fans can't afford to buy socks. Unbelievable. They're all going up the escalators. They're staring. It's a rock concert in the mall, and of course that I got to deal with this guy, Big Red. Me and Billy. Big Red, sorry.
Where's Bill Burr?
Uh-huh?
Yeah, where's Bill Burr? He was supposed to join us.
That's right.
I don't know. But me and Mike got Big Red here, and people are staring at us. This one girl, the hot girl just walked by and looked at us like, oh my God, here at this mall.
Hey, did we remember the money?
Yeah.
To give them?
Yeah.
That'd be funny if we stiffed them. Oops, sorry.
Yeah, for the rest of the country, we pick a very snooty mall every year.
Yeah.
And this year it's the mall at Short Hills in New Jersey.
Also have an update coming from the streets of New York here.
Yeah.
This is from a very, very reliable source of mine. The race riots have started. There's a garbage truck or something on fire at 48th between 6th and 7th. So they've started burning things, people. Enjoy. Enjoy the city.
Wow. Hey, I'm looking at Happy Typing Girl's Pal Talk camera. Anthony, you can finally see the camera. It is unbelievable how many people I'm looking at this mall right now. I can't even describe how many people. Just a wall of people. It looks like you can't even walk in the actual mall.
Who's that homeless fat idiot? Oh, it's Roland.
We're gonna get Big Red.
What?
All right. What do we got besides Big Red?
O-Town or something.
We got Big Red and O-Town.
All right, Rich, I'm going to put you on hold for a second. I'm going to go to Than. Than, what's going on today?
We're still just sort of in the staging area. I've taken refuge in a diesel store. It's just, you can't even move at this point. It's ridiculous.
I'm looking at cops, security mall cops.
I wish I could see.
And they're just all on their cell phones. They're trying to figure out what to do. I am now looking at a picture off Happy Typing Girl's cam. It is ridiculous. No one could walk. That's how crowded it is right now at the Short Hills Mall. And then they have a stairway to the second level, and you can't even walk up the stairs to get to the second level so you can look down at what's going on today. Unbelievable. Wow. Dan, is that pretty accurate or what?
I'm sorry?
Never mind. So you're in the diesel store?
Yeah, I'm gonna try to rattle my guys and get moving, so we're not all just standing around.
All right, very good. Yeah, we're gonna try to split up. You know, that's what happens every year. Yeah, they all go different directions, so maybe they could get some shopping done.
Oh, these poor people with a baby are trying to get by. That'll work.
Holy Jesus!
Are you looking
at that?
Wall. Isn't that amazing?
Up the stairs, the whole balcony. Oh, my God, that is a lot of people.
I'll check back once I get something going, all right?
All right, thank you, fan. Let's say hi to Sam. He's at the mall with his camera. Sam, what's going on?
It's a madhouse here. I took refuge in a store, too, and all the workers in the stores are just looking, trying to figure out what's going on, because there's nobody in any of the stores, but the crowds, the halls are so crowded, you cannot walk.
These are like disaster phone calls that you get, like when Katrina's happening and tsunami.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm taking refuge. There's pandemonium.
Refuge.
Yeah, they told me I couldn't bring my big camera in that I always use.
Oh no.
Well, you know what? There's going to be.
We have several small cameras scattered around the mall, so we'll have video.
Now we could use a camera.
What do you think?
I thought we could use a camera.
They won't. They can't. I mean, it's too big to hide, and it's
too big. They got smaller cameras,
and I'm not worried. I mean, we got a lot of pests in there with cameras. We'll get plenty of video of the event.
Sam, what I want to know is, though, did you tape the exit from the bus?
Yes, the entrance was taped. I got off the bus and taped them getting off the bus.
Very good.
How amazing was that?
What was that?
How amazing was that?
It was unbelievable. I mean, you can't. There was barely a path to walk. Mall security had to escort all the homeless off the bus, as well as our security.
How pissed off are they that they had to escort the homeless into the mall?
Oh, I know.
So, Sam, you got audio of the entrances, right?
Yes.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah.
Very cool. All right, and we'll have lots of video and audio and all that up on the website.
We're getting quick glimpses of what's going on, and it is unbelievable. I don't know who said it before, but all the homeless shopping sprees that we've done in the past put together is pretty much what this one is.
Yeah.
I've never seen so many people in one place like this in a mall.
All right, let's say hi to Fez. He's at the mall. Hey, Fez.
Hey, O&A.
What's
this
up?
This thing is gigantic. I can't believe this. This many people showing up for the homeless. If this many people showed up for the homeless every day, we wouldn't have homeless.
Yeah, right. Yeah, they kind of forget about them, and then we put on a little event, and thousands show up to see a few of these people.
And treat them like rock stars for an afternoon.
Yeah, now they're just beloved. Don't worry. Come Monday, they'll be getting kicked and spit on again. And they'll go back to normal.
All the stuff that the people bought them will be stolen from them.
So I got teamed up with Slow Motion, and which I really appreciate. Give me the slowest shopper possible to keep this going on.
Is it like shopping with Mother? It just takes forever?
Yes, exactly. And I know we're going to be trying on stuff. So what's nice is there's such a huge crowd, Slow Motion actually just went into the first store he saw.
Oh, really? What store was that? Victoria's Secret?
He's in Foot Locker.
In Foot Locker. Oh, they got to be thrilled to have a homeless guy trying on shoes today.
They all need shoes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah, exactly. Have a few hundred pairs of socks ready before he comes.
Oh, yeah. Oh, disposable for sure.
Fez. Hey, Fez, can you move around or?
It's really hard to move around. I mean, the Foot Locker, they followed us in here and it's just packed. And I'll tell you what. Everyone say hey to Ola Dad.
That's just one store, by the way.
One cell.
Foot Locker. That's one little cell, right. All right, Fezzy, hold on. We're going to check in with, you got, huh? We lose him? All right, let's go to Danny. Danny, what's going on?
I'm here with Papa Rock in a very nice sunglass store. And Papa Rock is making his very first purchase of the day.
Okay.
He's buying $90 Ray-Bans.
What an ass. See?
We only gave him $200.
I told him, I said, are you sure you want those? And he said yes, and he took out his gift card, and he's making the purchase as we speak.
$90 Ray-Bans. What an idiot.
Yep.
Good, his eyebrows will be warm during the winter months.
Well, I'm sure a fist will take care of those. They'll play some of that awful music and wake somebody, and a nice fist will remove his Ray-Bans.
Someone's just going to punch him in his Ray-Bans. $90 Ray-Bans on a homeless guy. This is how stupid these people are.
God bless.
That's why they're homeless.
How about just getting a $3 hat?
Yeah.
And $20 gloves.
And some gloves and boots and
a Cartwright jacket.
To keep it nice and warm.
And then maybe $20 sunglasses.
Yeah, then you get some cheap sunglasses,
man,
if the sun is bothering you. He's going for a look.
Yeah.
He's homeless, but he wants to look good.
Can we say hi to Papa Rock?
Let me try to get to the other side.
Yeah, he's like, no.
I can't even move. Excuse me, guys. Excuse me, I'm sorry. Excuse me. Hey, Papa Rock, the guys want to talk to you, okay? Yeah.
Hey, Papa Rock.
Yeah.
It's Opie and Anthony. You bought Ray-Bans.
Huh?
You bought some Ray-Bans.
Ray-Bans?
You bought sunglasses with your...
Yeah.
You bought sunglasses. Don't you think there's some better things you can buy than sunglasses?
That's okay, right?
Yeah, whatever you
like. Like stuff to keep warm with during the winter?
All right, we got to let
them
go.
Just eat them.
Yeah, just eat the glasses.
They all are completely incapable of communicating on a telephone. They are incapable.
They've talked to nobody but sheriffs and bill collectors on the phone.
Right. Let's say hi to Rich Voss again. Rich.
Hey, we're at Timberland, and we're getting Big Red. We're getting Big Red food, and people doing $140 in the...
Wow,
listen, this is how generous the ONA fans are.
Of course.
They said we want to get Big Red Timberlands, and they started throwing 20s.
Wow.
And we got
See, they're just drowning out Rich Voss, but basically they're throwing money at Big Red so he could get his Timberlands.
This is what happens. We give each of the homeless a certain amount of money. I didn't even know what it is.
Yeah.
But we give them a certain amount of money, and they can spend it on whatever they want. But the real cash comes from the listeners. They just throw money at these guys when they go to these stores. And like he was just saying, he wanted a pair of Timberlands. That's good for a homeless guy, a pair of Timberlands. And the listeners paid for it.
Hey, at least Red is buying boots.
Yeah, I know. Dope.
I just paid with a credit card, so now I got $140.
No. Freaking Rich. Rich is going home with some money today.
Give him the cash, Voss. Hey, Voss.
Oh, what do you want? Pants right now? Pants and a sweater. And listen. Red needs pants. It's smell. Unbelievable how it smells.
Horrible.
We want to thank the people at Timberlands. Thank you, man.
Why won't the mall out, pal talk?
That's ridiculous.
They're following me because I got the money in my hand.
All right. Hold on, Rich. We'll get back to you in a second. Let's go to Than. Than, what's up?
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey.
Well, Blue went instantly practical by buying a boombox at Sharper Image.
A boombox.
Wow.
That's going to be a boombox when it careens into the side of his head one night when he's sleeping. God.
Yeah, it's great because you can hook your iPod right into it. So.
Good for him.
I love these guys.
They're
unbelievably
not
practical. I love it.
They're not all practical.
I absolutely love it.
Why does he buy a bathing suit while he's at it?
Why are we surprised?
We're not surprised.
They're dopey.
And then they go back on the mean streets in New York with their brand new shiny freaking boombox.
Boombox, and it just gets stolen.
My God. Anything else, Dan?
Yeah, it says right on the price tag to ask about their 3-year replacement service guarantee.
Yeah, what happens if you come back and there's a boot hole in it and a Michelob bottle has been smashed against it? Does the warranty cover that? What happens if it gets broken over my head while I'm sleeping?
Pull a few of his last remaining teeth out of the speakers.
All right, I'm moving on. Let's go to Club Soda Kenny. Kenny, what's going on, buddy?
You can't imagine the crowd that's at this mall.
Thanks, Kenny.
Wow,
hey,
Kenny.
How come they won't allow them to use Pal Talk? What's the problem?
They got to do what they got to do. I don't know what.
What do they got to do? What is
that? Who knows? They're shutting down the Pal Talkers. I got a guy, Benny, at mall with Pal Talk trying to broadcast, but I got bounced. So I don't know. We'll figure it out.
I don't understand what the problem is with
Pal Talk. Did they say we could use cameras there?
Get Kenny back on. They also didn't expect who knows how many thousands of people to show up.
Yeah, but, you know, we want to get captured on tape.
Yeah. Well, people are going to be using their video phones and everything.
Oh,
so. Hey, Elmo. My brother's on the phone. What's up, bro?
I'm following you out a couple more blocks, and I'm in the block, which, of course, is the first stop in most of these bumps. And we have Love, the black bag. He is going to match the funds of our one bum named Dude.
Oh, he's at the Foot Locker because he said a lot of the homeless start out there getting some shoes. And one of the one of the fans are matching the funds.
Oh, matching the funds?
Given to him, yeah.
Fans are matching funds at Foot Locker. Very cool. Let's go back to Club Soda Kenny. Kenny.
Yeah.
So how many people? I mean, you're good at estimating crowds.
I tell you, it's standing room only. This mall is packed. Everybody with a baby skull abandoned the mall because there's no place to even walk. It's incredible the kind of crowds you got here.
And it's on both levels, too, right?
Oh, yeah. It would bring a tear to your eye if you were here to see this.
Well, teary eye.
The smell.
Right, yeah, he's talking about the smell. All right, anything else to report, Kenny?
No, I'm with...
All right, we lost Kenny. This is going to happen all afternoon.
No place for the phones.
Yeah, let's go to Roland. Roland, what's up?
Uh-oh. Hey, how are you?
Hey, Roland.
Describe the scene, Roland.
It's pretty much in Foot Locker and probably with people everywhere. And a homeless guy leaning on all the nice, clean t-shirts, stinking them up.
A homeless guy's leaning on all the nice sneakers.
Stinking them up in t-shirts.
Yeah.
Buying shoes.
Buying shoes.
A lot of people.
A lot of people, yes.
People, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, can you yell at them? And then he's playing
cheese. It's amazing that he can't even get excited in a mall with no.
But Roland delivers information like he's just picking up little keywords in sentences.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Scrolling it by him.
All right, let's say hi to Rich Voss again. Voss.
Hey, listen, he wanted to go get pants, but we brought him into Louis Vuitton. Right now he's looking at a tie, a nice Louis Vuitton. The salesperson doesn't want anything to do with him. And all the people, you got to see the faces, all the Asian people scattered out of here. It looked like there was a monster attacking. My friend here would like to try on a tie. He's got a big engagement to go to at the Port Authority this weekend. How much is this tie right here? $180.
If he buys a $180 tie,
I would say even though you're homeless and you have nothing in life, a $180 tie will make you big on the circuit. Okay. Should we get him a tie for $180? I say, you know what? Leave it. Okay, we're leaving the tie. He doesn't want the tie.
All right, he decided against the tie. All right, thank you, boss. Let's go back to Thin. We're just going all over the mall now. Thin, what's up?
Find him hanging from it.
Here at Sharper Image with Blue's new boombox. A listener was kind enough to chip in and pay for it for him.
How much?
Wow.
$100.
$100. So he's got his boombox. Blue's got his boombox.
And he's still got his cash, which is good because I'm sure their gift cards, they're going to want to use it for liquor later on.
Yeah.
They seem to enjoy that, and if they could maybe go out for a little late lunch, early dinner at one of the restaurants in the mall.
Well, if you remember from past homeless shopping sprees, Ant, a few of the guys go, you know what, I don't feel like shopping. They go right to the bar. I wonder if a couple have made it to the bar at the mall.
It does happen.
Well, a lot of them want to save it for the next day and do a brunch. They want to have a little brunch.
Let's say hi to Steve. First time Steve's checking in at the mall. Steve, what's up?
Just got done Foot Locker. James, a.k.a. Slow Motion, just got a brand new pair of shoes. Well, surprisingly enough, they don't hold on to them, their old shoes, after they get their new ones.
Yeah, where are the old shoes?
In the trash.
Biohazard.
Those would be a collector's item on the Opie and Anthony circus.
Sell them on eBay.
What's Steve?
Oh my God! They're like at one point the other guy, I think his name is Big Pop, took off his shoe and Jeff made him take off his socks, and his rancid busted up foot came out, and it just fucked up the whole place.
That is awesome.
And now it looks like we're moving on from this place.
All right, Steve, we'll check in.
I think Slow Motion wants some jeans.
Want some jeans? Oh man!
And they locked us in the Foot Locker.
What do you mean they locked you in?
The gate went down. The gate went down, and we're locked in.
Why are you locked in? That's odd.
Well, I mean, I think they wanted to keep everybody else out.
Oh.
So now I guess we have to make our way. We're caged animals.
Oh, wow. They had to pull the gate down to keep people out of Foot Locker.
They thought a bear got loose. No, I'm a person.
I know it's Jersey, and there's bears.
Very cool, man.
All right.
Very cool.
All right, Steve, hold on line. We're going to make sure you get out of Foot Locker. Make sure they get that gate back up. Let's say hi to Fezzy again. Fezzy!
Hi, O&A.
Hey, Fez.
I'm very far from my home. I don't live here. I'm not supposed to be here.
Don't get nervous. Get yourself some church pants.
Some warm things.
And now I'm locked in a Foot Locker.
Oh, you're...
I don't know if Steve told you or not.
They take that locker part pretty seriously, I guess. They lock you in.
They really do. This was nice. We got Slow Motion pair of shoes, a new pair of kicks, as the homeless kids say.
Yeah.
And he had to ask for a size 10 and a size 13.
Oh, God.
What? Because his feet are different sizes?
Yes. For one pair of shoes.
They're chanting, let us out.
It sounds like Rikers.
They're chanting, let us out.
Attica!
Attica!
Let us out chant.
It's a prison movie.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just like Cuckoo's Nest. So, relaxed. We're out of the Foot Locker.
All right, that's I guess why they uncaged them.
Yeah, I don't think they're going to do that again.
All right, thank you.
I could see if half a Hulk face was in there and they want to put the gate down and charge admission to raise the curtain.
My treasure.
Let's go to Rob in Jersey.
Hey, guys, how you doing?
I can't wait for the bill from Short Hills Mall to CBS Radio, by the way.
Oh, my God.
Rob, what's up?
You know, I got to tell you guys something. 2.5 hours, I just had to leave, right? Because there's so much action there that you can't even get close to it at this point.
Yeah.
But the best part about this whole thing, and I don't know if you guys are getting pictures of this, but... It's the old men and old women standing on the steps and on the second floor asking, like, what's going on and explaining it to them. And when they figure out what's happening, the look of disgust on their face, and they just can't believe that something so terrible happens in a town that's so happy.
No, dude, here's what you tell them. If old people ask you what it is, say it's a gathering of HIV-positive people who want to be allowed to shop there.
Absolutely brilliant. Thanks, guys.
Hey, thank you. The fans are checking in like crazy from all over the mall. Let's say hi to Luke in Jersey. Actually, I think Luke's trying to get to the mall. Luke?
Hey, what's going on, guys?
What's up, Luke?
Oh, man, I'm on 78. The line is incredible.
You're where?
I'm on 78 trying to get into the mall. The line is incredible.
You can't even get into the mall at this point?
You can't even get anywhere close.
Wow.
It's ridiculous.
I think we've pretty much shut down the mall at Short Hills today. Hey, thank you, sir. We're going to go back to Roland. Roland, what's up?
Hey, I'm here with
Brother Elmo.
What?
He's here with Brother Elmo.
Oh, all right. What's up?
I speak Roland.
We're stuck in the Foot Locker. This one guy, Marcus, he looks like Robin Williams in every dramatic role he's ever played.
That's who he looked like.
I said that.
Oh, you did say that?
Yeah.
See, I wasn't listening either, Jimmy. We're going to hear a lot of different things when we...
Shoes back.
What?
He keeps sending the shoes back. Different sizes, different styles. Very uppity.
Oh, good for him.
Oh, my God. Oh, he's trying them on and sending them back?
His dirty feet.
He's making a very, very cute Foot Locker girl work for her money, man. Holy cow. She's going to need 3 showers.
Oh, that poor girl.
So the guy, wait, he's trying on 2 different size shoes? And he doesn't like him, and he's sending them back,
and he wants new ones to come out. You know when you're uppity,
yeah.
And you just sit there and want to be waited on, and you don't like the style of shoe, and bring me a new shoe. This one's too tight. So he's being picky.
Yeah,
exactly. And one of the listeners went up and started pushing his toe, just like mommy used to do from the store.
Does it fit?
He's looking fit.
All right. Oh, you press where his big toe is supposed to be, and you just feel something crunch down like a dried up cracker.
Just break his toe.
Leprosy, yeah.
I mean, break his toenail right off his foot.
That big thing looks like a wise rippled potato chip.
It looks like a cornflake with like a little bit of glue under it.
All right. We're going to have to take a break. Thank you, Brother Elmo. Before we take a break, let's say hi to Sam, who's with Blue. Sam, what's up?
Yeah, we're in Timberland right now with Blue.
Yeah.
He's trying to get some boots. They brought in 11 and a half in the style he wanted, and he said he wasn't going to be able to fit. So he's trying to pick out another style.
Oh, he's trying another style. Okay.
He's got a ton of fans out here. They're following Blue around. They're cheering him, trying to get their pictures with Blue.
Yeah, the homeless love taking pictures with the homeless. Has anyone, who's with half a Hulk face?
I think Danny has half a Hulk
face. Danny? Oh, we'd love to hear from Danny and how the fans are treating half a Hulk face and what he's buying.
Yeah, we'll do that next. Thank you, Sam. We should take a break. We're in the middle of the homeless shopping spree 2006.
What a success so far.
Absolutely. So far, so good. Want to hear from more of the fans that are at the mall. We'll check in with Danny and the rest of the gang in just a bit. It's the Opie and Anthony Show.
Hey, it's primetime Sam Roberts from the Opie and Anthony Show, and you're listening to the 2006 homeless shopping spree on the worst of O&A.
There's my mic.
My
good
pants
one, Derek.
Down.
Thanks for hitting my mic.
Yeah, we're in the middle of the homeless shopping spree 2006 on the Opie and Anthony Show. It's a virus, the ONA virus, spreading across America.
Derek just made fun of my pants.
Oh, they just saw me with my pants down on Pal Talk.
You came running out of the bathroom with your, pulling your pants up, zipping and buckling your belt. And then Derek was making fun of my pants because I have zippers on the back pockets.
Do you really?
Yeah, I didn't even know.
What a fruit.
I don't buy my pants.
I mean, him for noticing.
You didn't know you had zippers on your pants?
On the back pockets. I have apparently have zippers on them.
You had no idea.
I don't buy my clothes.
What are you putting?
Yeah, but you put on your own clothes and you're walking around.
Yeah, but I just kind of look at the front, and then by the time I put them on, what do you think? I look in the mirror like girls do, and over my shoulder on a full length mirror, and look at my ass.
Oh yeah.
What's the design on the back pocket? You get a design on the back pocket. Like a little. It looks like a half a club, like on a playing card.
These pants are officially gay. I'm instructing my girlfriend to never buy these again.
Yeah. Next time, buy them assless chaps. They're more masculine.
Let me say.
Ew.
Ew.
Jesus. What's wrong with you?
We might have to put out an all-points bulletin to get you some jeans at the mall at Short Hills.
My pants are officially gay.
You gotta stop shopping in Chelsea for your clothes. Go into Soho. Go to Diesel or something.
All right, listen. Let's go to No Filter Paul. We got to get right back into this. The phones are nuts. It's the homeless shopping spree 2006 at the mall at Short Hills. It's No Filter Paul checking in. What's up, Paul?
Hey, guys. I'm in Macy's, and we're homeless Fez and Dave and your brother Elmo. And they're all looking for jeans and coats. And it's 75 people trying to help them find the right size of shirt. So it's pretty out of hand in here.
At Macy's.
At Macy's, huh?
We're getting people just giving us stares of, like, what in the hell are you people doing here? It's like a swarm of bees going through here. That's pretty cool.
That's good at buying clothes. That's what you should buy.
Yeah, I know. Well, see, this shows you the cross-section of the homeless. Some of them actually have sense enough to buy some clothes, and others get Ray-Bans and boom boxes.
Yeah, so far, what have they purchased? Yeah, some Timberlands, Ray-Bans, and a boom box. Let's say hi to Danny. He's with half a Hulk face at the mall. Danny, what's up?
Hey, guys. How are you?
Good.
Good. Yeah, I actually went outside because my phone was having some trouble getting a signal in there. But after we activated the gift cards, because obviously they weren't, we
half a hog face made a beeline for the Apple store.
Why, does he want to put one on the other side of his face to even it out?
And, he just got himself $25 worth of iTunes.
Wait a minute.
What's he going to play them on?
I guess I said, do you have an iPod? And he's like, yeah.
Are people following him around?
Oh. Yes, yeah, so he's got a crowd of people around him. Like I said, unfortunately, I had to run outside because my cell was crapping out.
Hey, Danny, see if we can get somebody else in there. Is there anybody else with you that we could get on the cell phone, like, from that location with him?
I'll try. I'm going to have to run back inside.
All right, see if we can get him on the phone through someone else's cell phone.
Yeah, that would be great. Thanks, Danny.
Yep.
All right, yeah, if you're following half a Hulk face around, give us a call. Let's say hi to Than. Than, what's up?
We're in Foot Locker. Buying sensible shoes for Grey Wolf.
Sensible shoes.
Sensible.
What are those? They don't sell moccasins there, do they?
No.
Moccasin locker. what is he getting? Boots or something good for the winter?
Just some sort of high top sneaker.
Oh.
All right. Are you guys all split up at this point?
Yeah. But they're actually. I guess the policy here is to close the metal gate after the homeless get in here. So there's a whole bunch of. Fans just waiting to get in outside.
The homeless are shopping like Paris Hilton shops.
Yeah.
And like big celebrity shop. They go in the stores and the stores close down. Exclusive service just for that person.
You know, security got together, had all sorts of meetings.
And
this is what they decided. Okay, when one of the homeless goes into one of the stores,
you
pull down the gate.
This will keep the crowds from coming in and perhaps having an inventory loss. Then when the homeless want to leave, lift the gate again and release them.
I got to tell you, the gang at the mall at Short Hills showing they got a good sense of humor so far.
And they got their security together.
Yeah.
They're doing the catch and release program with the with the homeless.
Let's get a Nick in Jersey. Nick, what's up?
How you doing?
Hey.
I'm just in the mall, and the look of disgust on some of these people's faces when they ask what's going on and you tell them.
Yeah.
There's famous people there. And one of the homeless guys screamed in his little kid's face when he was coming in the door.
What did he say?
Yeah, what did he say?
He just yelled in his face. Just, ah!
Oh, good. Kid will have nightmares forever.
I'm sure it smelled wonderful.
All right, very good. Let's go to Steve from Long Island. Steve, what's up?
Hey, guys.
Hey.
What am I doing? You're in my effing mall.
Frunkus.
I haven't heard many frunkuses
today. I want to know if there's frunkusai. If that's the proper plural.
Frunkies.
I want to know if there's a Santa Claus in there.
Oh, yeah,
if there's
man.
A mall Santa. Mm-hmm. And I want pictures to be taken.
Yeah, definitely. Drew, what's up?
Drew.
Hey.
Logan.
What do you got, Drew?
Hey, you're on the air, idiot.
All right, he lost his chance. Let's say hi to Keith the cop. Keith, what's up?
Hey, what's going on? I'm with the Big Red and Big O with Rich Boss. Big O just got himself a nice leather jacket. It cost about $250 courtesy of the band that Rich Boss wants to let us know. He put 50 of it in.
Wow.
Hey, that's pretty cool.
A nice leather, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's going to be submitting an expense report, he told.
Of course he will.
It's tax deductible.
Hey, Keith, is there a mall Santa?
Yeah, we're going to try and make our way over there.
Good.
I think these people really believe that Big Red is Tippy Tom. Girls are kissing him, and he's making $20 for making out with girls.
He's not making out with girls.
I'm telling you, he's kissing girls in the mall, bro, and they're giving him $20 to do it.
Dude,
holy Jesus.
What? Would you kiss a Petri dish?
Why?
For $20?
These must be some slobs.
But, yeah, I think there's, like, three groups of Macy's right now. We're trying to move out. We're going to head towards the Santa, and I'll give you guys a call back.
We got to get half a Hulk face on Santa's lap.
Yeah, I want half a Hulk face on Santa's lap.
Yeah, that is the photo op right
there. That is the Christmas moment.
Absolutely. Danny, what's up?
Hey, guys. I think this is better. I'm on Billy's phone.
Yeah, perfect.
Good.
Actually, I'm with half a Hulk face. We're in a boot store, and he's trying on shoes.
There's a theme here. A lot of homeless guys getting the new boots.
Getting the boots. He's getting one for his chin.
Yeah, he really wanted Doc Martens, but we didn't see any yet, so I think he's going to have to settle for something else.
Well, he should call Doc Kevorkian and get that face fixed.
All right, it looks like the homeless are settling in and getting their shopping done.
Doing
now.
Some shopping. We've had some irresponsible purchases. Danny.
Yeah.
Did you hear what's his name? Who's the rocker?
Papa Rock.
With
Papa Rock.
Did you hear what Papa Rock bought?
Well, didn't he get sunglasses?
Yeah, the $80 Ray-Bans.
Hey, 90. How far 90. Are you from the mall, Santa?
I don't know. I haven't seen them yet, actually. So I'm going to try and find them right after Hulkface makes his next purchase.
Yeah, because we really want Hulkface to take a picture with the Santa Claus.
I'd love
Claus.
To see a Hulkface in half a Santa hat on Santa's lap.
Yeah, get him a Santa.
Get him a Santa hat.
I will try and find one. That's going to be my next point.
Because sometimes they have those little kiosks in the mall where you can get a Santa hat and have, like, you know how they put the glue and glitter, a name on there? Try to get him to put half a Hulk face on the front.
Or half Hulk?
Half Hulk, whatever, half Hulk face.
Half dash A dash Hulk.
Half a Hulk and sit on Santa's lap with that hat. If you can make that happen, Danny, goddamn, you're the best.
Yeah. I'm gonna try my damnedest, I promise. Right.
Thank you, Danny. Let's say hi to Ron. He's at the mall, one of the listeners. Ron, what's up?
Hey, what's up, guys? How you doing?
Pretty good. What are you seeing over there?
All right, well, I'm above where the Foot Locker is, where they have a homeless person in at the moment, but they need to go on the second level above to an MAC. They do makeovers. We have to bring half a Hulk face into here. This will be hilarious.
For a makeover?
Oh, my God.
What, like makeup and what do they do? How would they give a guy a makeover?
Oh, I'm really not sure, but if they have these people in here, the workers, they look like transvestites to begin with. But
I just want to see the horrified look on their face when they don't know what the hell to do.
Chainsaw.
They come out with ball peen hammers and chisels.
Hey, Ron, thanks for the idea. We're going to get one of the guys up there.
Half a Hulk face, makeover.
Yeah, definitely.
What's better than that?
Let's go to Voss. Voss, what's up? Your guy just bought a leather blazer?
Yeah, we just got him a leather blazer and a nice TKNY sweater. He's the best-dressed homeless person I've ever seen.
They said you chipped in $15.
What's that?
They said you chipped in $15.
I put in 50 out of my pocket. And also, I got a coupon for some Jewish kid. And we went past this little girl was crying when we walked by. I think she recognized me. Fred is tuckering out right now. It's like he's almost out of it. He went to the bathroom. He can't even barely walk. Here, talk to Mike for real quick.
All right.
Hello, boys.
What's up?
My man, Randy, is scared.
What?
He's on his last leg.
Oh, he's on his last leg?
Oh, man, we walk him to death.
Yeah, he hasn't walked this far in a long time.
Oh, boy.
He needs to see a forklift.
Yeah, by the way, by the time they get back on the bus, these guys are out cold.
They're exhausted.
It's a long day for them.
They're like little children all falling asleep in the back seat, coming home from a holiday out.
All right, we'll check in with you guys in a little bit. Let's go to Steve C. He's with Slow Motion. Steve C., what's up?
Hey, guys, what's up?
Hey, man.
Oh, we just got out of Macy's, and we were getting these guys some pants. I had no idea until we got to the register how little money that Slow Motion still had on his card left because the woman at the register looked at me and said, you don't have enough money. All this guy had bought was a pair of shoes. I looked at the receipt in my pocket. His sneakers cost $175.
He bought $175 sneakers? Well, you idiot.
This guy's going to get so mugged so quickly.
Oh,
I'm going to mug him. I'd love to have those.
Why?
No idea.
What am I asking why for? Yeah.
Same reason the other guy bought a boombox.
Exactly. Dopes.
No idea. So we got him a cheap pair of jeans and a pair of shoes and a really expensive pair of shoes, and now he's all cleaned out.
And now he's out of money.
He's
got $175 sneakers.
Steve, are you going to buy him anything?
And when we walked into Macy's, everybody thought it would be real cute to go to the perfume counter and cover us all in women's perfume. So we all smell like some weird combination of Obsession, Dracar, and God knows what.
And homeless ass.
Yeah, and homeless armpit. And I can't help, and I really can't thank Anthony and Jim enough for sparking this one. I can't walk 2 feet any direction without hearing a grr or that's terrible. I'm sorry.
Oh, that was a good one.
Anyway.
Are they gurring at you, Steve?
Yeah.
They're gurring him. Gurr.
Gurr. Where he goes. All right, Steve. We're going to go with Sam. He's with Blue trying to get a picture with Santa. Sam.
Yeah.
What's going on?
We're trying to get a picture. Blue really wants a picture with Santa Claus.
Who wouldn't?
Santa's on break.
Oh, Santa's on break.
Oh, conveniently Santa went on break? What is that about?
We've got some boots so far.
Don't make the listeners start a chant. Where's Santa sitting?
Where is Santa? How long is his break?
Big Blue, let's holla. Blue is shouting at me. I can't hear you.
Do you not? Is there a sign that says Santa will return January 5th?
I know.
the crowd is, again, the crowd is huge.
Poor Sam.
Blue has made $50 so far panhandling to the people here. He's got cash in his pocket. They're buying him, they bought him a boombox already.
Yeah, panhandling.
More than any other hobo.
Oh, that's great.
Hobo. Listen,
Jesus, Sam.
When they get back in the bus, it'll be fun to really find out what these guys bought.
Yeah, what they
it's
got.
It's hard right now, but when they get back in the bus, well, it'll be very clear what they ended up buying. All right, Sam, we'll check in with you in a little bit. We're going to go to, let's go to Nurse Heather. Nurse Heather.
Hey, no, it's not Nurse Heather, a different one, but I'm at the mall. We're outside the sunglass store. I can't see who's in there, but everyone's out here. They're, one store shut the doors on them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that seems to be policy today.
They just don't. They're probably worried about getting ripped off. They can't watch everybody.
Yeah.
You know, all these
miscreants.
Yeah, I
think that's probably what the biggest problem is. They don't want to be shoplifted from.
But they are. They seem to be handling it okay.
Yeah. Anything else, Nurse Heather?
No, they're just buying sunglasses now, and they hit up Foot Locker already.
Okay. Right.
Thank you. We're going to check in with Black Earl. Earl, what's up? Earl.
Hi, Earl.
What's up, Earl?
Yeah, we're buying sunglasses for everyone right now. I mean, the place is absolutely jammed. We tried to buy Fed some pants, but we couldn't find his size. But,
couldn't find his size?
Yes.
You got to go to a tall and portly store?
He's a 40-30.
We couldn't find his size. The best part of this is, like, when you walk through, there's our listeners who have completely packed out the place, and the looks of horror from the regulars. It's priceless. I mean, this one girl, she just had this, it looks like a very permanent look on her face. It's just like, ugh. And she couldn't break it. It's like, everyone's laughing, everyone's having a good time.
Yeah, no one can really understand how upper crust this mall is. They would rather have zombies that mall, like Dawn of the Dead or one of those zombie movies at the mall than they would the homeless.
All right, Earl, thank you. We got to go right to Roland because Roland is saying that his bum is very picky. Roland!
Hey, yeah, I'm with Marcus, the most picky. He tried on 5 jackets before he bought it.
5 jackets were destroyed jackets before he picked one.
And then he tried on, like, 5 different hats, and he goes, I don't want a hat.
Oh, he tried on hats? Are they just crawling on the floor now?
Yeah, the hats are crawling away.
The hats are moving. They're shoplifting themselves.
He told me the shopping man thirsty, so here at Starbucks.
What was that, Roland?
His shopping made him thirsty.
Shopping made him thirsty?
Thirsty.
Well, maybe they could go to one of the restaurants that are there. In the mall and sit down and maybe grab something to eat real quick and something to drink and
have a soda pop
and get back to shopping.
Yeah, but he wants a Starbucks.
He wants Starbucks? All right.
Yeah.
Thank you, Roland. We're going to go back to Danny. Half a Hulk face. Looks like a listener is buying him boots for $200.
Yeah, he decided on $200 boots.
Jesus.
And one of our fine listeners decided he was going to pick up the tab and then some. I think he's getting him some nice thick socks to go along with those boots.
Nice.
Wow, that is really cool.
Yeah,
our listeners are really nice, and I almost hate that.
And that ass, Matt, what was his name, Noise, who said that we were just going to be exploiting them? And here all these people are buying them clothes and having fun with them and not abusing them and
thousands
treating them nice.
Thousands of people treating them like rock stars.
Taking pictures with them, giving them money.
Yeah.
Yeah. They're rock stars for a day.
And so what? They make fun of how they smell a little bit and, you know, how goofy and stupid they are buying stupid items like boom boxes. Big deal.
I love
who
this
cares?
One guy who's picky, though.
Yeah.
The one guy's picky.
He's picky.
He's a fuss budget.
Fuss budget.
All right, Danny.
These guys are making out really well, and everybody's behaving. This is going to be working out better.
Cool. Well, Danny, how about half a Hulk face? Two things, small Santa and makeover.
That might not be a bad idea. We're going to try and find the mall Santa, so hopefully we can get that done.
Yeah, we hear he's on a break. You make sure this isn't no bull crap break, and he's really on a break.
Yeah, we might have to start a chant until Santa reappears there.
And find out.
We're going to find him.
Find out where the makeover thing is. Have to get a makeover. Have a whole thing.
We heard it's upstairs.
You know what? Maybe we'll try and hit the makeup counter at Bloomies.
All right, cool. Breaking news. Let's go to Alan. Alan, what's up?
Hey, we actually just left the mall. The entrance from 24 is closed off by the cops.
They have shut the mall.
They have 2 cop cars blocking up the entrance.
Wow, the mall's closed.
We just closed down the mall until we leave.
We saw all the guys come in. Next time, can you put name tags on these guys so we know who to cheer for?
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah, we forgot the bullhorn, unfortunately, so I'm sorry about that.
Well, thanks a lot, guys.
All right, let's go to Jay. He was at the mall. Jay, what's up?
Hey, guys, how's it going? I just left the mall, and the dumbfounded, rich, snooty crowd is like, oh, there must be some football player here because it's all just a bunch of guys.
Some football player.
The mall is so snooty, they don't even have a food court. If you want to eat in this mall, you need a reservation.
Even the old people there recognize it's a sausage fest.
All right, great job. Punching out.
All right, let's go back to... Kenny's checking in, too. Cool. Let's go to Than first. Than, what's up?
Well, this is the portion of the trip where the homeless go to the John.
To the John.
It's the bathroom trip. Okay.
Dude, the clean mall bathrooms, they love them.
Yeah.
Blue is just... He's just a crowd favorite. He works the crowd. He gets them to sing.
Blue, you want to sing a song?
Yeah.
Let's go, Blue.
Come on, y'all. All the birds, Mr. Star, y'all
enjoy the play. What song is he singing?
Jingle Bell Blue. Yeah,
the Blue doesn't let not knowing the words stop him at all.
He didn't know the words to Silent Night either, that dope.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to head into the can, and then we'll try to get some more fun going.
All right, thank you, Fan. Let's go to Rob in Jersey. Rob?
Hey, Rob.
Go ahead, real fast, Rob.
Yeah, Stan has been on break since 2 o'clock, man, ever since he heard you guys were coming.
Yeah, he better get back out there.
It's little sign says he's feeding his reindeer. What's he got, like 1,000 of them? What's going on?
Yeah, all right, cool.
I bet you that they heard that we wanted to get Santa pictures, and they,
Yeah.
I think a chant going is going to have to happen to get Santa back. I mean, there's no reason that Santa should not be there. These homeless people need Santa more than anybody.
Santa should absolutely be there.
It's a mall on a Saturday. How is he on break at 5?
Come on.
Get Danny on the phone. We got another idea for Half a Hulk Face. Club Soda Kenny, what's up?
I'm in Starbucks with Marcus the skateboard dude. Santa Claus ain't coming out. He's hiding until we left.
He's hiding until you guys leave?
Yeah. Marcus the skateboard dude made out of light. He's got new sneakers and a new coat, and the fans chipped in about $40 extra for him, and he's buying his own Starbucks right now.
He's getting a little Starbucks for himself. Very good.
And then we'll go to Innovation Luggage to get free stuff next.
Hey, Kenny, breaking news. They shut down the mall.
Yeah.
No, the cops are blocking the exit to the mall, the entrance to the mall.
Let me tell you something. You guys definitely left your mark on this mall today.
Well, yeah.
Unbelievable.
Be cleaning for months.
All right, very good. Thank you, Kenny. We're going back to Danny. Danny, what's up?
Hey, guys. We're on our way to Macy's. We're going to get Half a Hulk Face, a nice makeover there at the makeup counter.
Good boy.
Oh, great.
Can we get that ear pierced?
Oh, my God.
Hey, Half a Hulk Face, can we get your ear pierced? No.
That, no.
He doesn't want to look silly.
Yeah, that would look silly.
That would look ridiculous. Oh. All right, Danny, thank you.
Yeah, huh? And Papa Rock will not stop complaining how bad he wants a beer. So I think after that, we're going to go try and get him a beer to shut his mouth.
All right, there you go.
All right.
Papa Rock is a drinking problem.
He could.
I don't want to speculate, but
Milt? Sometimes if they go to a restaurant, sometimes it's nice to have a, you know, they have a Mexican restaurant over there. You have a little taco and then Corona. That's nice.
Let's go to Milf for you from Whack Bag. What's up, Milf?
Hey, everybody's cheering, waiting for Santa Claus, and we're outside the Gap. I think Tippy Tom is in the Gap now shopping.
They're calling him Tippy.
Yeah,
isn't
good.
That great?
Excellent.
Good.
Oh, hello?
It's like when they change Darren's on Bewitched. No one cares. No one really, it doesn't bother them. He's the new Tippy.
It's the new Bo.
Right.
So he's in the Gap now looking for a new outfit.
All right, very cool. Yeah, I think we might have to start a chant where Santa's supposed to be sitting because that's not cool.
They're all outside here yelling. Yeah, Santa's. Yeah.
All right. Maybe we could get one of the guys on the phone that's near Santa. I want to hear the chant they're doing, all right?
Hang on. Let me find someone for
you. All right,
baby.
All right. Let's say hi to Wayne. Wayne in Jersey, what's up?
Hey, guys.
What's up, Wayne?
Yeah, I was just standing outside Sharper Image about 10 minutes ago.
Yeah.
And this snooty woman kind of pushed her way up to the front of the crowd. And she walked back to her husband and just said, like, really disgustedly, there's nobody famous in there.
Oh, is that great? That is,
they think it's a celebrity.
Snobs. They are celebrities.
They are celebrities for a day.
Trust and fear and people heading for the exit.
Oh, that's great.
Good. Get out.
Good job, guys.
All right. Thank you, sir.
Later. All right. Harmless.
MILF.
Hang on. I'm trying. No one's yelled. They're all in the gap watching Tippy Tom shop.
All right.
Can you see what he's getting?
I'm looking at a spy camera right now, by the way.
Are you?
Very interesting.
Oh, damn.
Very interesting.
Security's not letting anyone else in the gap.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I know. They're doing a good job, the security over there.
Yes.
All right. Call back if you get if you got any info
no problem.
On the chant there. Okay.
Okay, thanks.
Maybe we should take a break?
Yeah, I think that Santa should be out there taking photos with the homeless people.
We might have to see if Santa is available.
Yeah.
The homeless shopping spree has to end with something with Santa.
Yeah. We want Santa Claus.
Come on.
Yeah, let's... oh, here's Fez.
Can't deny.
Fez.
Hi, boys.
Hey.
Fez at the homeless shopping spree. We are on our way to see the man himself, Santa Claus.
Now, we hear that he's on this break that he's been on since 2.
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear that one.
We hear that he's on a break, and he's been on a break since 2 o'clock this afternoon, and he won't come out.
Really?
Yeah, we might have to get some listeners to maybe entice him to come out a little bit, if you know what I mean.
Sure. We'll do what we have to do. I've tried to find pants for myself.
Yeah.
We've been to Lane Bryant. Peanut Pod, Maternity Store. And really nothing that's fitting right so far.
Really? It's a little tight around the hips?
Yeah. If there was a store called Mom's Jeans, I'd be all set.
Well, good luck to you, Fez, in your search. I hope you can find good church pants.
Yeah.
And don't forget Ronnie's, your cigars.
You know, I'm teamed up here with Slow Motion and Big Pop. Big Pop tried on a hat at one place and was forced to buy it after trying it on.
Forced to. He couldn't take it off. Those little crab claws were holding tight.
All right. Thank you, Fezzy.
There's a sign there. If you infest it, you bought it.
Let's say hi to Keith the Cop. Keith, what's up?
Gentlemen, I've just ended my negotiations with the union that represents Santa Claus. And we will have a 5:15 shooting with all our homeless people and Santa Claus in the center of the mall outside Macy's.
Bravo. Spread the word.
Ah, there you go.
Keith, spread the word, because when we get back from break, we want to gather at that point, okay?
So rally up by Santa.
Rally up the troops.
Rally the troops by Santa.
All right, let me go. I'm going to hit all these guys on the radio. I'll talk to you in a minute.
All right. Oh, yeah, they got radios and everything there. All right, we got to take a break. We're in the middle of the homeless shopping spree 2006. Woo! What a day, what a day.
If we could tell somebody, let that person know to get by Santa.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And here are the headlines right now. They have shut down the mall. They're blocking the entrance to the mall at Short Hills.
Couple of police cars.
They're not allowing
nose to nose
any more cars into the mall area until we leave.
Shut it down like there's been some kind of a nuclear leak.
That's right. We have completed hostage negotiations.
Right.
And Santa will be making an appearance, even though he's been on break since 2 o'clock.
They actually had to have police negotiate like he's a jumper.
Hostage negotiations went on today.
You don't want to do this to yourself.
Right, right.
Santa, please, please come out. You don't want to do this. You've got to come out and meet the homeless and take pictures with them. Santa, your mother is here. Please come out. Please, Santa, they'll do horrible things if you don't come out.
Spy cam, heading to Santa.
To Santa.
And what are some of the other headlines? Half a Hulk face getting a makeover probably after the break.
We have to. Or at least after his Santa picture. I think he's got to do Santa and then the makeover, because it seems like we have the Santa in about 10 minutes. We got to do the Santa first.
Yeah.
Let's say hi to my brother Elmo here. Elmo.
Oh,
As the fans feed our egos.
That's great, huh?
We will continue with the Homeless Shopping Spree 2006 on the Opie and Anthony Show. Thanks, Brother Elmo.
Oh, my God. Stand back.
No, you'd have to get the kids out.
Get the kids out.
Oh!
Here comes security. It's the Homeless Shopping Spree, only on the Opie and Anthony Show.
Wow.
We're back. It's the Opie and Anthony Show. You're listening to the Homeless Shopping Spree 2006.
Shaping up to be a huge success. I'm looking. Well, let's just say I'm looking. Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
And the crowd's just growing.
They're all behaving.
They're just growing and really proud of the fans. You know, no joking aside here, they're behaving themselves. We're a crazy show, but in the end, we really do try to behave and just have a really, really good time. So, it's the ONA virus spreading across America really fast. We got to give some love to Break.com. It's also up on YouTube, but we did another TV commercial for XM this time around. And Break.com, they've been great to the show lately. Yep. They threw the commercial up on their front page, which is unbelievable because they only had like two or three videos a day on their front page. And they decided to help us out, and they threw the commercial right up there on the front page of Break.com. So if you're a faithful listener of the show, could you please do me a favor? Go there, check out the commercial that way.
Yeah.
And then show Break.com some love and, you know, check out some other videos. We're starting to really, really love Break.com. We're working together here, and it's nice.
Thank you.
Thank you to Break.com, yes.
And look for it on TV.
On TV starting Monday.
That's what it's there for.
On the television.
The television. It's actually pictures sent over a cable or sometimes the air, I hear. And, yeah, you're able to see them on something called the television. It's nice. It's like radio with pictures.
Let's say hi to Keith the cop. He's organizing the homeless. Keith, what's going on?
Gathering our last couple purchases, and Santa will be meeting us in approximately 5 minutes for our group picture and sing along.
How'd you get How'd you get him out?
What's that? I'm sorry.
How'd you get him out?
Well, we convinced them that we wouldn't leave until 7 o'clock if they didn't bring him out.
I'm telling you, there was hostage negotiations going on with the mall Santa.
There's a helicopter waiting outside to take him to the airport where a 747 is waiting.
He's going to have to leave the way the strippers left in Apocalypse Now.
Yeah.
Throwing down flares with people hanging off.
It was pretty much a back-and-forth negotiation with the time we would leave if we brought Santa out.
All right, cool, Keith. We'll check in a couple minutes here, all right?
Yeah, as soon as I get them all together, we'll check in.
All right, thank you. Let's go to Katie. She doesn't get it. Katie from Jersey, what's up?
Hey, what's going on? I don't get the whole concept.
Well, we got a bunch of homeless people who we come on the show and we get to know them, and then we give them money, and the fans give them money, and they shop in a nice mall, and they buy stuff that they need.
Something sure. They would never be.
Why do you turn the Short Hills Mall into a breeding ground for white trash?
Because you guys are really snooty in that mall.
Yeah.
But you ruin shopping experiences for me, people like myself who are trying to do Christmas shopping.
Well, what people? Overprivileged white people? Too bad. Deal with it.
No,
well,
but
I kind of like her point of view.
You're not doing it to help them. If you're doing it to help them, then you would have bought them stuff and not make a mockery of it.
We do buy
shop somewhere else, you spoiled whore.
We do buy them stuff.
Shut up, you spoiled whore.
Shut up, Katie.
Why don't
Katie.
You die? Get knocked up by a non-white and shop somewhere else, you overprivileged whore.
That's exactly right there is why we go to the snooty malls every year.
Deal with it, bitch.
Ruining her shopping experience, a breeding ground.
Yeah, for white trash.
There you
go. Our listeners, and they are white trash. I can't argue that.
Of course. She had one valid point, so what?
There you go. That's why we do it, though, right there.
Ruining the shopping experience for me. What do you got, Daddy's Amex? Going to buy yourself a little something?
Ha-ha. That's I love the fact that we're annoying people today.
Absolutely.
Sorry, honey.
That's right.
Let's go to Fan. Fan?
Hey, what's up? We're trying to make our way over to Santa.
All right, yeah. It seems to be the thing, the word's getting around that it's time to meet where Santa is.
Yeah. Have you spoken to Sam yet?
No, why?
Just he's with me. I wanted to make sure I'm not covering the same ground.
Hey, is Santa out yet, Fan?
Let me...
Let me run over there. So far, Grey Wolf has destroyed the bathroom.
Yeah, they have tendency to do that. The homeless, they really take their toll on the bathrooms.
Yeah.
It's like a carpet bombing.
I mean, they're trying to make up for lost good bathroom experiences. They start squeezing their wrists and working their way up the arm like tubes of toothpaste.
Pours out of them like space food.
Hey, I see Santa.
Oh, wait a minute.
One of the spy cams is following Santa. Santa just raised his arm in the air because everyone else just noticed Santa.
Let's go to the phone. Are they cheering him?
Yeah, let's hear.
Let's go to Danny. Danny, what's going on? Danny.
What's going on?
I'm in here. I'm with the show.
All right, hold on. We'll get to him in a second. I think this will help us out. Mill, for you, what's up?
Hey, Santa just came by. They're all waiting for him to, I guess they're all taking pictures with him now in front of a fountain, so. They all just yelled, and the Gap threw on everybody out, so they chanted the Gap sucks.
Oh, the Gap threw everybody out?
Gap threw everybody out. Santa has arrived. Steve is with Santa, helping escort him to wherever he's supposed to be.
Santa's right here. No, he's not even going to his chair. He's just in the middle of this chaos taking pictures.
Someone's got to make sure Santa gets to his chair, because it's got to be a legitimate shot.
No, it's not working. Keith is backing everybody up, and Santa's just taking pictures in the middle of this chaos, taking a picture. There's no way he's making it to the chair.
All right. Thank you, Milf. We're going to go back to Danny. Danny, what's up?
Guys, we have Santa.
All right.
Everybody is crowded around Santa. We're going to get a nice group shot.
It's not about him.
Red just almost took out 10 people. He's falling over everything.
I see security. I see Santa. I see a lot of people on both decks of the mall. Wow. A little bit of a longer shot. That is nice. Lots of people. Santa, the homeless.
We got spy cam. We spy cam on Santa. This is so cool. Gotta love the pal talkers that made it inside the mall with their equipment.
We want individual shots of Santa, too. We don't want a whole group
shot. A group shot in the middle of the crowd. I want him sitting in his chair, and I want each homeless to be able to go up and take a picture with Santa.
And tell him what they want for Christmas.
That's right. All right, Danny, thank you. Let's go to Cameron in Connecticut. Cameron, what's up?
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey.
I just wanted to say, I think this is an awesome idea that you guys are doing. And first time I actually got through on the show.
Oh, welcome.
All right.
And that lady that said that you guys are turning into a breeding ground for white trash.
Yes.
She's just ignorant and stupid.
And that's why we go to a mall like the mall at Short Hills. Thank you, sir. Let's go to Kenny. He's with Santa. Kenny!
Yeah, we're taking our picture with Santa Claus.
Oh, I see it. The spy cam.
Yeah, and they're singing Christmas carols. This place is packed out, standing room only, on both floors, the balcony overlooking. Everybody yelled at Santa when he made his grand entrance. We're taking the photo now. I think Big Red got a problem with Santa.
What happened?
I don't know. But it's off.
He's homeless.
Here.
That's why he's got a problem with him.
Wow, I'm looking at the Pal Talk camera. A lot of this stuff will be up on opieandanthony.com later on this weekend.
Wow.
We got to thank Innovation Luggage for giving us the free stuff, too.
Yeah, they gave backpacks to all of our homeless. I'm looking up on the balcony now, seeing people looking over the edge. This is huge.
Standing room only this year.
The amount of people that showed up for this and the outpouring of generosity.
Yes.
The money that the listeners are giving to the homeless.
Wow.
Completely out of character for them.
All right, we got a guy that works at Short Hills. Let's say hi to Mark in Jersey. Mark, what's up?
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, Mark.
It's just pretty funny. Like, all the managers are walking around with walkie-talkies, like, waiting for you guys to come in the store, like, getting prepared just in case something happens.
You know, it's also good. This thing, they have a plan. You know, they have things going the way they want it to go, but I think the longer it goes, the more kind of like, all right, enough of this they're getting. Like, they don't want it to go this long.
Hey, did you guys have warning before we came?
What's that?
Did you guys know before we came that we were coming?
Yeah, actually, one of my managers listens to your radio show all the time.
Okay.
Ah.
And the store managers are making, like, a lot of people stay in the store, like, the managers.
Yeah.
Just in case you guys come in. I think it's funny.
Keeping the brass in there.
Yeah, very good. All right, we're going to go to Sam. Thank you for that, Mark. Sam's with his camera. Sam, what's up?
Hey, man. Big Blue has this thing
under lock. He had a couple holding his bags for him the entire time.
He had people holding his bags? Like when the rich and famous go shopping.
Yeah.
He got his picture with Santa. He got new pants. He got boots. He got a belt. He got a boombox.
He did all right. I think Luke did really well.
He did.
Yeah.
All right. Did everyone get their pictures with Santa?
What did you say?
Did everyone get their pictures with Santa?
Yeah, it was a group shot, but everybody got a shot with them.
Wait, a group shot? Why did they do individuals?
I think it was too much pandemonium there.
Oh, yeah, what I was seeing.
It looked like, from what I could see, they couldn't even get Santa to his chair. It was just too packed. Unfortunately.
We're trying to get under the bus now.
All right, I think the homeless are heading toward the bus. Let's say hi to Greg in Jersey. Greg, what's up?
It'll take him a while.
Hey, guys.
Their bad, scabby legs.
Hey.
Just want to let you know, I think I have line of the day, actually, too. There's two black ladies outside of Nordstrom's going, "What the phone about?" The other one goes, "Well, I think it's for the Opium and Anthony show."
Opium?
And
wonderful.
I'm with my friend Mandy, when we were waiting for everybody to come in by the main entrance, she goes, "You know, I feel like this is the 4th of July. I'm waiting for Macy's fireworks to go off."
What about a picture of Have a Hulk Face? What about Have a Hulk Face's makeover?
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
We don't have any of the guys on the phone. Travis.
Yeah, where's Have a Hulk Face?
Let's go to Bob in the meantime. Bob in Jersey, what's up?
Hey, what's up? Hey,
Bob.
Just want to let you guys know, the Livingston Mall, which is like 3 or 4 miles north, has got to like an orange alert in case you guys make your way up there, too.
Oh, well, now I see Santa sitting down in his chair.
And
little children are being brought over.
Yeah, I see that too now.
All right, I want Half a Hulk Face over there.
Half a Hulk Face to the Santa chair.
Yeah, let's...
Half a Hulk Face, Santa chair.
Danny?
Stat.
Hey, guys.
Can you...
we had some... They escorted Santa away immediately after the group shot.
Yeah, but I'm seeing Santa right now in the Santa chair with children on his lap.
Oh, he came back?
We want Half a Hulk Face in that lap.
We need Half a Hulk Face to take a picture with Santa in the chair.
In the chair. I will see what I could do. It was to my knowledge that Santa was going bye-bye, and we had a...
Yeah, well...
Get Keith or Kenny with you for that one.
Put it this way. I'm looking right now, and he is sitting in his chair.
Get Keith or Kenny with you on that one.
What's that?
Get Keith or Kenny with you on that one to get that picture, Half a Hulk Face in Santa's lap.
Yeah, he gets his picture.
All right, I'm going to see what I can do.
All right, thank you, sir. Let's go to Craig. Hey, Craig.
Pull a fast one on us.
Yeah.
I guess Craig was at the mall. Craig?
Yeah, what's up, fellas?
Hey.
Hey, I was standing upstairs, and we're looking down on a homeless fellow with the guitar. His name escapes me right now. And the lady's walking around with her kids. She said, "Yeah, I saw this guy in concert back in the 70s. He's a big rock star." Trying to get her kids down there to meet him. I explained to her what was going on, and she was like, no, he's a rock star.
He's got to be.
Oh, because she sees people following him around.
Wearing Ray-Bans.
Crosby, Stills, and garbage.
What a day for the homeless. What a day for shopping. Everyone's getting into the spirit of Christmas today.
Yes.
Yep. Thin, what's up?
We're sort of, looks like we're kind of moseying towards the exit. Blue is charging people by the word for his bad carol singing.
For what?
Apparently $1 gets you jingle. And it's a sort of sliding scale after that.
Sliding scale. He's charging people money to sing carols. I think he's exploiting people.
I see Santa with two adorable kids on
his
lap.
Two little kids are on his lap right now.
Yeah.
I want one ugly one.
Yes.
All right, then. Anything else you got?
It looks like we're kind of missing the bus right now.
All right, thank you, sir. Let's go to Kenny. Kenny, what's up?
I don't know. They said you want to talk to me.
We want to get half a... Santa is in his chair taking photos with kids. We want a Half a Hulk Face on Santa's lap, or at least there in that chair photo. So we want either you or Keith to go back with Danny, because you guys are better negotiators than he will be.
He's sitting in his chair right now.
All right, we were about to get on the bus.
Well...
How far?
You want to go back with Half a Hulk Face?
Yes.
Just Half a Hulk Face back to the Santa chair, because we're watching him right now. He is sitting there, and children are sitting on his lap, and he's there. He didn't go away.
Yeah, this spy cam's kind of creepy.
Yeah. Yeah,
Deb is good.
All right, let me take care of that right now.
Thank you.
Thank you, Kenny.
All right, bye.
Let's go to Jake. He was just at the mall. I think he just left. Jake?
What's up?
What's up, Jake?
Yeah, I just came from the mall. And, oh, my God, I heard girls, they're, like, saying, "Oh, I can't believe they're here. I don't want to be here. Let's leave right now." It's snooty little pussy girls and everything.
Good.
Yeah, I think we annoyed some of the pussy
happy.
Girls
I just
today.
Started laughing in their face.
Good. That's what they get.
Yeah, there are some.
Rats beat it.
Real snobs.
Yeah, right on.
Good. This will show them.
Hey, E-Rock, you got...
Now that is the best.
Wow. Yeah.
Look at him run. Opie turns around and goes, hey, E-Rock, and looks at his post, and it's just empty. E-Rock. Have you ever seen Kirk turn around and go, Spock, where the hell did Spock go?
E-Rock, give me a choice of homeless bits we can play. I don't want to take a break. I just want to take a couple minutes to kind of regroup here. Eli in Brooklyn, what's up?
Hey, Jimmy, you're a comic genius, but you blew the joke.
Oh, no.
Crosby, Stills, and Trash.
Damn it.
Ah, very funny, Eli.
Crosby, Stills, and Trash.
Thanks, Eli.
Good one.
Hey, can we play Homeless for the Holidays? Is that a good one? All right, let's play this, and we'll return. We're not taking a break. Just listen to this.
You've heard them go shopping on the Opie and Anthony Show. Now hear them sing. K-Smell Records and the Salvation Army present Homeless for the Holidays.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride on a goddamn Chevrolet.
Spend Christmas with your favorite homeless lunatics. You'll hear all the classics. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had a very shiny nose just like yours.
Deck the Halls.
This is the season to be jolly. La, 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 la.
And who could forget Ziggy's haunting rendition of Silent Night?
Silent Night.
And if you call within the next 10 seconds, we'll throw in as an added bonus, the making of Homeless for the Holidays, featuring never-before-heard homeless outtakes.
I'll take your gun and shoot you in the head and shoot all these motherfuckers. Let me off. Let me off. Let me off. I'm tired of shit. I said I'm tired of shit.
Off key, out of time, and smells horrible, it's Homeless for the Holidays. Get yours today. Call 1-800-HEPATITIS.
I love that.
God, I forgot about that. One guy like is panicking and wanted off the bus.
Yeah.
Let me off.
It's the Opie and Anthony Show, by the way. Let's say hi to Danny. Danny?
Hey, guys. We're trying to make a deal with the mall to let him back in. It's kind of difficult because we're all outside now waiting for the bus, and they won't even let us back in. So we're trying to hammer something out with the mall, who's been great to us, by the way.
Yeah.
To see if we can get back in.
All we need is half a Hulk face with Santa, for the love of God.
What
not a group
get
shot.
Back in? They can't tell you not to come in.
So you guys
You know what it was? Where that group shot was with Santa, that wasn't the actual Santa picture taking spot.
We know.
No, we know that. We got this spy cam on.
We're looking at Santa sitting there with children being brought to his lap.
Yeah, I mean, Keith's working on it. Kenny's working on it. Everybody's trying to get him back inside to get this done.
All right. You guys are pretty much outside now?
Yeah, everybody's outside. The fans are outside. All of our homeless are outside.
You got a nice crowd to whatever. I'm tired.
They can't wait to see the homeless off.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to say. Thank you.
Yeah.
Crowd now sounds tired too. All right, hold on a second, Danny. Hold on. Let's say hi to Sam. He's outside with Blue. Sam.
Wow.
Sam?
Sam.
Yeah.
What's up, Sam?
We're outside. Blue, get over here. We're outside. We're waiting in the parking lot for the bus. We're trying to hold Blue in one spot. Blue's got a pile of stuff that he's had people walking around with him for. The look of disgust on half the... There's about 100 people at this mall who didn't realize this was happening.
Yeah.
And the looks that they were giving Blue when he was walking down the hall is priceless. Just disgust and confusion.
It's great. People show their true colors, man. I love it.
Disgust and confusion.
I love when people show their true colors.
Yeah, look at that.
We had a wonderful time.
All right. Thank you, sir. Let's go to Brother Elmo. Elmo.
Hey, man. What's up?
Hey.
It is still pandemonium. We're outside waiting the bus, and there's so many goddamn people here.
And you guys getting ready to get back on the bus?
Yeah, we're getting back on the bus. The funny thing is so many people were generous, giving money and all that.
Yeah.
Some upper crust lady handed me coupons to Subway restaurant for 99 cents of a 6-inch value sub. I thought that was a little interesting.
Coupons for Subway.
for Subway. Everyone else is calling like $20, $10, signals from the rafters.
Yeah,
snob.
All right, hold on 1 second. I got breaking news. I think Big Red just fell over. Than.
Yeah, that's pretty much what happened.
What happened?
I'm not sure what he's been up to, but he's I don't know, maybe somebody spun him around a lot.
Oh, he's a little woozy? It's probably just the excitement, the merriment, all the people. It kind of goes to some people's head. They get a little swoony.
A little overwhelmed, yeah.
Yeah.
He kind of collapsed into two of our health and security fellas, and his hat came off.
And his hat came off.
Did he have a good time?
Oh, this is great. Everybody's got lots of impractical stuff. And,
yeah, very impractical.
Yeah.
Geniuses, all of them.
Tad from Myrtle Beach saying it all. You guys have to have the greatest effing staff in the history of radio. Yeah, these guys did an amazing job at the mall.
Stepped up.
Than, thank you, sir.
Hey, thank you, guys. Talk to you later.
All right, back to Elmo. Elmo.
All right.
Did Kenny go back in with half a Hulk face?
Say it again?
Did Kenny go back inside with half a Hulk face?
Okay.
He doesn't. You can't hear me?
I can barely hear you.
All right, hold on. Let me say hi to Fez. He's still inside. Fez, what's up?
Hey, we're just waiting for the bus to come take me home.
Oh, did you have fun, Fez?
There's a bus that's coming, right?
Yeah, don't you worry. It'll come and take you back home.
I was always the kid that was last at a birthday party. My mom always was like 2 hours late picking me up, and I'm feeling the exact same thing right now.
You won't miss the bus. It was very scary as a kid to miss the bus from school or stuff, but don't worry, you won't miss the bus. Do you have your little name
half
tag
a Hulk
on?
Face is getting his picture with Santa.
Oh,
hold on,
I
gotta go, Danny.
Hey, guys, half a Hulk Face is getting his picture with Santa as we speak.
Have that guy move out of the way of the camera. There we go.
It just happened.
There it is.
We got a spy cam on Santa. Half a Hulk Face got his picture with Santa Claus.
Bravo.
I think that's the grand finale of the homeless shopping spree right there.
That is the picture we wanted.
We accomplished everything we set out to today.
Yes.
Awesome, Danny. They obliged, huh?
Yeah, they finally agreed to it.
They saw it our way. Good.
Said we'll release all of them. We won't even take them back. Just threaten them with that. Say they're homeless. We don't have to take them anywhere.
Yep.
Just leave them there at the mall.
And now the spy cam is following half a Hulk face out of the mall. I see Club Soda Kenny with a huge smile on his face.
Yes, mission accomplished.
We'll get Kenny on the line in a second here. Thank you, Danny.
You got it.
All right, let's go to Whack Baguette. Whack Baguette.
Good morning, guys. Good afternoon, boys. I had a great time today. Your staff was excellent. The homeless guys were great. Everybody was tipping in money for them, and it was excellent to see the Yankees absolutely go crazy. And you know what? That stupid city from New Jersey who had a problem with those people, you should go back to a stupid big mansion in Short Hills and eat her Godiva chocolates and die.
Yep.
Ooh, well angry. Said.
I didn't hear all of it, but it sounded
pretty
bad.
Big mansion and eat Godiva chocolates and die.
And
die.
Snob.
Very nice, yes.
Take care, boys.
Bye. All right. Yeah, it looks like everyone had a great time. They're making their way to the bus now.
There's Danny.
Abe in Jersey.
Hey, what's going on, guys?
Hey, Abe.
Hey, man, great time. I got there about 2 hours early waiting for you guys. The crowd was amazing, huge.
Yeah.
And just to let you know, I had a few conversations with some of the managers of the Short Hills Mall there.
Yeah.
A lot of them were actually on the opposite end of their opinion. They were, they were happy you guys were there. They said the snobby little shoppers, they deserved it. And
a lot of the people that work there have to deal with.
Guys.
Thank you, Abe.
They got to deal with those snobs all day.
In the end, our listeners spent a lot of money at the mall. Let's go to Club Soda Kenny. Kenny?
Yeah, you just had a half a Hulk face sitting on Santa's lap.
We saw it.
Yeah, we saw on the spy cam. Unbelievable job.
Yeah, and then by popular request, they wanted me to sit on Santa's lap, too. And he was insulted because I put my leg over his.
Did you really?
Yeah.
Creep.
He didn't like that.
You are a creep.
You guys heading toward the bus now?
Yeah, we're headed toward the bus. This was a huge success and another unbelievable R&A event.
All right. Thank you, Kenny.
We definitely want to hear the big send-off.
All right, no problem. We'll be ready for that in about 2 minutes.
All right, actually, we're going to take a quick break, so stall just slightly for us. All right, Kenny?
All right, cool, no problem.
All right, the big send-off when we return. It's the Homeless Shopping Spree 2006 on the Opie and Anthony Show.
Hey, it's E-Rock from the Opie and Anthony Show, and you're listening to the 2006 Homeless Shopping Spree here on The Worst of Opie and Anthony.
You're listening to the 2006 Homeless Shopping Spree. And now it's time for Getting to Know the Homeless with your host, Steve C.
What's the worst thing about being on the street?
Well, you go into a place and they won't serve you.
Well, you are covered in dirt. You do realize that, right?
Stay tuned for more of the 2006 Homeless Shopping Spree here on the Opie and Anthony Show.
Go get lost!
You're checking out the Opie and Anthony Show. A little different today. It's the Homeless Shopping Spree 2006. Where are we at? They did their shopping. They are getting on the bus as we speak.
We got the Santa picture with Have a Hulk face, which I just want framed so I can hang it in my house for every Christmas from now on. What a great
ornament.
It actually looks photoshopped right out of the camera. Looks like you use some type of facey stretch program.
Yeah, let's say hi to Keith the cop. Keith, what's up, buddy? Keith, by the way, you had the worst phone today.
I totally apologize. Anyway, we're just waiting for Master Paul to finish up his demonstration that he's doing. Yes, crowd. And we're getting on the bus. Everybody,
you homeless. Thank you, homeless.
They're thanking the homeless.
Thank you, homeless.
The fans were great. They treated us absolutely outstanding, and the most successful homeless shopping spree we've had.
How cool is that to hear our listeners going, thank you, homeless?
Well, for the rest of the year, it's not thank you.
No, it's...
There's a you in it.
Yeah, well, there is, sure. But once a year, they're treated like rock stars.
That makes you feel better, stepping all over them
right.
For the rest of the year.
Keith, what are your thoughts?
I think the most successful one we've had, the fans... Spent a ton of money in this mall today. Everybody got treated to a lot of extra stuff on top of the money that we gave them.
Right.
And everyone couldn't be happier, including the staff, the mall staff, the security. It went off great.
Right.
Thank you, Keith.
Thanks, man.
The only people that were upset, of course, were the horrified enthusiasts that are in the mall.
All right. Let me go around the horn here. Than, what's up?
All right. Well, we've got everybody back on the bus. And I don't know what we're waiting for, but we're just getting everybody squared away.
Yeah, everybody's got their goodies. Are they talking about to each other about what they got, or?
They're very solitary. I don't know. They seem shell shocked. Somebody gave Blue some really, really delicious Gatorade.
Oh yeah.
Okay, that's nice. That replaces electrolytes.
Looks like he's hitting the spot, yeah.
And is so good, annoyed.
Good for him.
I love it. All right, let me go to Kenny. Kenny!
We're pulling up right now. We're saying goodbye to about 1,000 people. It was really an incredible event. You guys should be very proud of yourselves.
Well, you guys, too. You did a great job out there in the field.
We got to personally thank the mall security guys and the mall management because they really did us right.
Good, man. Excellent. Thanks, Short Hills Mall.
Yeah.
All right, we're pulling out right now, saying goodbye to everybody.
Saying goodbye to about 1,000 of our fans that are there for the
send-off.
As
the
they send-off. See the bus off back to New York, where these people will summarily be dumped back onto the street, now with valuables on them.
Let's say hi to Steve C.
Hi, boys.
Hey, Steve.
Steve, hello, Steve. How are you?
I'd like a Valium and a quart of vodka.
Did people really garret you all day today?
What's that?
Did people gurr at you all day?
Oh, my God. I couldn't walk in any direction without people just going, gurr, gurr.
Gurr, gurr. That's really terrible. That's terrible.
Fist in their upper middle class faces.
Hey, Steve, were they talking to you like the impression of you?
Yes, they were.
How great is that? Good.
Thank you, Jim. I really appreciate that.
I love that he has to walk by and have people going, hello, Steve.
Hi, Steve.
Was everywhere. I couldn't walk in any direction in any store without someone going up to me and going, hello, Steve, how are you?
Why not?
Why not?
Thank you. It was, and I think I need a bath.
Great job today, man.
Yeah, what are some of your other thoughts there, Steve?
my opinion of homeless people has remained the same.
They stink.
I really don't like being any closer to them right now than
who
I did.
Would?
It was we actually at Brookstone, Big Pop bought actually spent the last of his gift card buying a young lady an inflatable neck pillow. He spent $80 buying her inflatable neck pillow.
Well, what a dope.
That's nice and sweet and all, but why?
Who, the rock guy?
No, one of the guys that Keith got, I guess, at the last minute, Big Pop, one of the big black guys. He was being smooth. He was putting the moves on her. He was sitting in a massage chair and decided he wanted to buy her a present and spent the last $80 on his card buying her an inflatable neck pillow.
You know how much alcohol that idiot could have bought?
I know, at $80.
20,
yeah.
20 minutes worth. Why didn't he just buy it for himself? He sleeps in the street.
Why not?
I have no idea.
How did your neck pillow pop?
Hey, Steve, have you guys pulled away?
How did your liver die?
we're back on the road now. We're heading back.
All right, very good. Yeah. I'm seeing a little slideshow that's up on one of the cams of pictures that were taken.
Yeah.
This is great. I'm just watching on Pal Talk. One of the cameras has a slideshow of pictures that have been taken, and just crowds of people. Unbelievable amounts of people packed wall to wall. They go the entire length of the mall. And I'm looking at another live camera of people still milling around outside after the bus is already gone, sharing experiences, I'm sure, with each other.
Yeah.
Memories that will last an hour or two.
Oh, wow. Something else just happened. Than.
Shooting, I hope.
Than?
Yes. This is, I guess, truly a holiday story. Grey Wolf, apparently, when he gets off the bus in New York, is going to be meeting his son for the first time in 27 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
Now, how did that get hooked up?
Do you want to talk to him for a second?
Yeah. Yeah, sure. He won't be able to understand us.
Yeah, well.
Hey, Grey Wolf. What's up?
What's up?
I got my son on my phone, right? And when he was 3 years old, I did a bit. And I never got to see him for 24 years.
Went to jail.
He's 27 years old now. And he called me last Friday. Today he wants to meet me right on the show. He's on his way from Connecticut to come down with his wife and his kids. I'm a grandfather.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
How do you feel?
I'm emotional.
Yeah.
My son is listening to us right now. He's on my line.
He's getting a little choked up.
Grey Wolf, what? I got a question for you.
Yes.
What is the first thing you're going to do when you see your son for the first time?
I don't know.
Oh, you suck. You suck. That ain't even close to being right. And here I am, an idiot. I'm sitting here waiting to hear, like, maybe what he'll do. Bam. Oh, just an emotionless cyborg.
Wait, no.
Oh.
We have to get rid of
Well, I'm gonna click. Who cares? Oh, horrid.
Can we get video of that meeting?
I'm sure. I would love that. If we make sure.
Sam, make sure Sam has his camera rolling. So we have that.
I do want to ask Grey Wolf, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, let's say hi to Rich Voss. Rich.
Hey, what's going on?
What's up, buddy?
He littered in front of Grey Wolf because he's got a tear coming from his eye right now.
Yeah, he's a bit emotional about his son. He actually sent out a smoke signal and it just got to him, is what happened. His son wanted to see him years ago.
His ear to the floor on the bus.
One wagon, four horses.
I know. Here's the thing. I just realized how hard it is to be homeless. These guys are all over the place, but everybody was so nice to us, but the gap is the worst. There was a bunch of pretentious salesmen. It was like we got thrown out of the Gap by Nathan Lane. It was horrible. And the girl, the little sales girl going, this is a mockery of homeless, okay? You know what? You're a salesperson at the Gap. Shut your face and work the register.
A mockery?
I wonder if that was the same girl that called us.
Mm.
I'll bet you that was the same snooty little brat that called us.
How is it a mockery of the homeless to take them, have them get the adulation of thousands of people, and then have a bunch of people spend money on them and let them get warm clothes and ridiculous other items for Christmas? How is that exploiting them? Yeah, we have fun with them just like we do when anyone else comes in the studio. We goof on everybody, each other. And to goof on a homeless guy, what are you going to talk about? The way they smell? It's horrible.
Wait, Rich, so the Gap threw you out.
How can you exploit them when you're not going to talk to them for another year now? You know what I mean?
Wait, the Gap tossed all you guys out. That to me is a nice way to treat the homeless.
Yeah.
They're not good enough to shop in the Gap. Their money isn't good enough to spend in the Gap.
Around the holidays.
Yeah, but all of a sudden they want to, you know, they're donating all their money for disease cures. That's all their billboards until the disease walks into their store.
Literally.
What a bunch of snots. What an elitist, snotty store.
All right. Let's thank you, Rich. You did a great job, man, for us. I really appreciate it.
Thanks, man.
All right. Let me say hi to Danny. He's on the bus. Danny, what's up?
Hey, guys. How's everything?
All right. You guys got out of there alive, I see.
Yeah, it was unbelievable. I mean, I can't even believe the amount of people that were buying these guys' stuff. They really came to the table.
Yeah. Are you observing some of the gifts? What did everyone get? That would be pretty interesting as we wrap up the homeless shopping spree here.
Wait, they said what now?
What did they end up buying that we don't know about?
Oh, well, actually, to be honest with you, they spent so much time just dawdling that they didn't really get to many stores.
I mean, jackass, lazy, homeless idiots.
All they wanted to do was go drinking. I mean, it really showcases the reason why these guys are...
They can do that every other day of the week. Why on one day when they're able to actually take advantage of other people and get some things they could use for the winter, do they have to spend it being lazy and drinking booze? Can't they just take one day off from taking their life off?
This is the only time this winter they'll be able to drink indoors.
Yeah, exactly.
That's why they want to have a drink. Sit down and enjoy a beer without being punched and bricked.
Well, at the very least, they have the balance of their cars they could spend elsewhere.
All right, Danny, get a sing-along together. I'll go back to you. That's okay. How we're going to end, all right?
Tell them the gift cards work great for jimmying doors open, too, if they want to rob people.
Let's say hi to Brother Elmo. He did a great job, too. Elmo, what's up?
Hey, man, yeah, we're all on the bus here just kind of talking about what went on, the good and the bad. A lot of bad, but a lot of good.
Yeah, like what? What's some of the bad?
Some of the bad, you know, some of the people working behind the counters were pretty awful. But the guys me and Roland had, they were really, everybody was really cool helping us out.
Well, Elmo, why were they awful? They were rude?
Yeah, you know, it's a mockery of, you know, these homeless people, that kind of stuff. You know, we heard that a bunch, and we just ignored them and just went to other people who are more than willing to help out.
Good. Very good.
Yeah. Creeps.
It was good. Our one guy, Marcus, you look at him and you could tell why he's a homeless guy. He's just a psychopath. But instead of buying stuff, he wanted to go to Starbucks, sit back in a nice cozy chair and enjoy a nice latte and chat with the customers. So we were like...
like a real person.
Yeah. Kenny was losing his mind trying to get him out. It's like, dude... You know, you could buy some stuff. What are you doing?
He wanted to be, again, if we can bring up Shawshank, he wanted to be like the guys on the roof drinking the beer that one day.
Yeah.
Just drinking beers like regular guys on the roof. And then you're back in prison again.
He was like the Elephant Man when he got his shaving kit and he delicately dabbed a little Cologne on his stupid neck.
Cologne.
And he tried brushing that rotten head with his little human comb, those little wispy cancer hairs over that giant mountain of a head.
He just wanted to go into a Starbucks for one day, a few minutes, and actually not get kicked out, be able to buy something, and sit there like a real human being.
Like a gentleman.
Right, gentleman.
I think he's just a psychopath and has nothing to do with that. He kept trying on different ones. One of his feet apparently is larger than the other one, so it was just a nightmare.
Like a run over by a bus.
Like gouging
tire marks on it.
All right, Elmo. Great job. Thank you so much.
Good job.
All right, guys.
All right.
It's a dope. Bye. So President can go get, like, scuba gear.
Yeah.
Idiots.
Why would that guy spend $80 on a neck pillow for some chick?
Why?
Buy it for yourself.
Unbelievably
it's funny that you—it's funny that you guys are trying to figure it out.
Yeah,
you know how many meals you could buy with that?
I know, they just do.
You're homeless, dope. You go to Burger King for a month on that.
Yep.
Let's say hi to Fez. Fez.
Hi, boys.
Hey.
Gap, may I help you? Hello.
How did it go, Fezzy? Do you want to maybe go out and party with these guys for a little longer, or are you about ready to come home?
Yeah, I think I'm about ready to call it a night. I did it. This was a really interesting experience. I found out that Grey Wolf is a real father.
Yes, he's a father and a grandfather, we have found out. That's wonderful.
Hey, Fez, is there a party in New York tonight?
Yeah, it's going to be a Calico Jacks. It's a RonFez.net party, and it's going to be a Calico Jacks in Manhattan, 42nd Street at 2nd Avenue, starting around 9 o'clock.
Can I go?
Yes, you can.
What time is it going till, Fez?
I'll probably go till the place closed down.
Okay. Yeah.
All right, we'll go check that out tonight. Thank you, sir.
I have to go take a really long, hot shower before I'm ready to party.
Fez, did you find any friends, maybe, that you make any friends that you might want to invite over to Retard Island and, I don't know, maybe hang out, watch movies, something like that?
You know, I met a lot of nice people today. I thought it turned ugly. I thought they were chanting, Rich Mall Suck. And then it turned out it was just Rich Voss Suck.
Ah, okay.
Yes. All right. It wasn't ugly at all.
All right, very good. All right, we're wrapping up here. Thank you, Fezzy.
Thank you, buddy.
All right, we'll see you tonight at that party. Let's say hi to Kevin. Kevin, what's up?
Hey, O&A. It's great. Just got out of the Short Hills Mall. Great event tonight.
Oh, thanks.
You guys are great humanitarians.
Awesome.
Tree says nothing on you.
Very cool.
Yeah, another Rich Snooty story. I think while Fezzy and Blue were in Foot Locker, there was this Snooty guy talking to one of the fine officers who was helping you guys.
Yeah.
He was just like, I'm all for the homeless, but not when I'm shopping.
There you go. All for them, but not while I'm shopping.
All right, sir. Thank you. Let's go to Pete in New York. Pete, what's up?
Great time today, boys. The wife and I went on the motorcycle from the studios. We followed the bus all the way to the mall. We had a great time.
Yeah, it was great weather for this.
It was perfect. It was absolutely perfect.
It's like the Lord himself was sponsoring this event today.
Yeah. Let's go to No Filter Paul. No Filter Paul.
What's going on?
Hey.
And the mall's pretty much emptied out now. Very successful home shopping spree. Very good job.
Yeah, thanks for all the help, man.
Yeah, what was the highlight for you, Paul?
Everybody getting thrown out of the Gap and all the people behind the counter getting all snooty with everyone.
Everyone has said that was the worst store was the Gap by far. What elitists.
Yeah, absolutely. The more high-class stores were much nicer to everybody. The Gap. All these young black girls, they just snooted and went, I'm not dealing with these people.
All right, well, I guess they're all too good to deal with homeless people around
Interesting.
Christmas.
Interesting.
Over and over again, we're hearing that.
Yeah, the Gap was atrocious to everybody. Nice. Very nice company.
All right, sir. Thank you.
See you later, guys.
Yeah, we want to say thanks to Sam. Sam, great job today.
Thank you. Steve wasn't the only one attacked by impressionists all day. Apparently, a lot of people wanted me to see their cameras, too.
Oh,
what were they
my camera.
What were they saying, Sam?
They were saying, look, Sam, here's my camera. One lady was asking me to do movie reviews, and I figured out she was just trying to get me to say something with a short A in it.
I love it.
A short A?
Yeah.
Camera.
Camera or whatever, yeah.
Camera.
God, we have the greatest fans ever.
Yeah, they don't let anything go.
Ever. Thank you, Sam.
Yeah, my pleasure.
Make sure if you're on the bus there when... Grey Wolf's son meets him.
Yeah.
You videotape it with your, what is that thing?
We lost him. I'm sorry there.
Camera.
Can we get to Grey Wolf again, though? I do want to get to him before we go at one point.
Club Soda Kenny.
Hey, what's up, boys?
Hey.
Man, I'll tell you, I think Big Red made out the best. You believe he had chicks paying him $20 to kiss him?
I don't believe that.
Yeah, someone else said that.
Why?
Was going on today.
How did that start?
I don't know how it started, but there was a line of chicks paying him $20 a kiss. Unbelievable.
That is weird.
Doesn't make any sense. The guy, I don't get it.
Yeah, we don't get that at all.
Yeah, but everybody, another fabulous time. I got to thank you guys very much.
Yeah, you guys did an unbelievable job, man. Really. It was the best one yet.
If it wasn't for you guys, this never would have happened.
Well,
it all to you too, and little Jimmy too.
Oh, you're such a doll.
Hey, Kenny, what was the highlight for you?
The highlight for me?
Highlight.
I don't know. Just coming back to see you will be highlight for me.
All right. Thank you, Kenny.
All right.
All right.
All right.
Keith the Cop, another great job this year. Thank you, Keith.
Thank you very much. I appreciate the accolades.
Yeah, what was the highlight for you?
I think the picture with Santa was definitely a highlight. I saw some tears from some of the homeless guys and the horror on Santa's face. But, They're probably going to have to de-louse the suit again this year. But.
Yeah. What's the mood on the bus right now?
A couple of them are taking their nap. And
like, you know, children.
When we get back, we're all going to go out to dinner and dump them back on the street where they belong. They can look in the window as we eat lobster and steak.
Very good, Keith.
The phones are now lit with everyone back in their cars with their impressions of what they saw today. Keith, just unbelievable. Thank you so much.
Always a pleasure.
You never disappoint. It was just a great homeless shopping spree this year.
Another success, yeah. All bigger than ever.
We work on next year.
All right, thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
We'll see you guys when you get back. All right, Jordan in Jersey. Jordan?
Yeah.
Hey.
Yeah, no one had a clue what was going on.
Yeah.
Like, people would ask, oh, what's going on? And everyone would tell them random shit. we were in front of the Gap, and this woman asked this guy what was going on. The guy was like, oh, they're having a real big sale. And the lady just walked away like, oh.
Yeah, they had no idea.
Thinking there's a couple of thousand people there for a sale.
Right. All right, sir. Let me go to Mark. Mark, what's up?
Hey, what's up?
Hey.
One of the guys bought my girlfriend a pillow in Brookstone, and it was so sweet. She's so happy. It was so insane there. You guys don't know.
The homeless guy bought the pillow for your girlfriend?
Yeah.
Make sure you rail her while it's under her head and thinking of him.
All right,
yeah,
sir.
Yeah, it was great. You guys rock.
Thank you, sir. Another person that was at the Gap, Max in Jersey. What's up?
Hey, yo, I was at the Gap when it all went down. What happened? There was a girl behind the counter. She was talking about how their money was no good here and refused to serve them. So that's when everything started, getting worse and worse.
That's the only complaint we've gotten.
What a snotty bitch. Just what an awful, awful store.
All right. Thank you, sir.
Terrible.
All right. Yeah, we got to wrap up now. Yep. Let's say hi to Danny. Danny, we got a Christmas carol out of these guys or what?
I don't know. They're kind of tired, but I'll see what they can do.
All right.
All right, guys, you want to sing one more? How about Santa Claus is coming to town? You guys know it?
Damn thing.
All right, you ready? 1, 2, 3. You better watch out. You better not cry. You better not tell us what you want. Santa Claus is coming to town. Open the avenue. I love you, kiddo.
All right, guys. Thank you so much. I hope you had a good time.
Fuck him in the ass. You can't say that, right?
Oh, no. That's Red again.
What a pig.
Red is a pig.
I think that's it for these guys.
All right, man. I guess that does it for the homeless shopping.
Yes, what a success.
The staff did an amazing job.
Great job. Thanks to everybody.
Yeah, absolutely. The pictures and the videos will be up on opieandanthony.com in the coming, hours at this point. All right, yeah. And check out the fan sites, Whackbag and OAExperience.com for video and pictures of this year's homeless shopping experience.
A big success.
A big success. All right, thanks for checking us out today. We greatly appreciate it. It's the ONA virus spreading across America.